joining us in special comments along with Ken Petrucco. Thanks to Peter Curtin, Barnaby Willis and Peter Rosenthal for joining us pre-match. Umpire Davidson has the ball in hand. Simon Petch, take it away.
Okay, first term about to get underway. Grand final day 2009, up they go. And Purse got the first tap there for Zavs. Charging through, Ryan handball, Clark handball, back to Agius. Great tackle by Shields. Brought into ground, he knows he's in a game of footy, will have a ball up. Gee, what a tough tackle from Shields. Agius certainly knew about that. Thrown in the air again, into the first 30 seconds. Purse again wins it for Zavs. On hands and knees, Nethersole. And once again, same area. Just centre wing, just forward off centre towards Eli Sell's goal. Another ball up.
Frenetic tackling in the first 30 seconds. Ruck contest. Purse tries to get it away for Zavs. We said it'd be open flowing, Simon. At the moment, the ball's gone 12 metres in three ball ups. And we're going to have the fourth ball up of the afternoon. Gone 50 seconds in the grand final. No one can get a clear possession away. Darvell tried to get it. And once again, we're going to create a record here. Five ball ups in the first 1 minute. Both teams obviously get the score. No one's had a kick or a handball.
No, not yet. May see it. If someone can just thump this clear. Now this old try. Purse got on the way. Kick away there by Darvell for Zavs. Inside 45. Mercury met it beautifully. Left foot kick into goal. And Lynch has marked it.
Oh,
dear me, no. He's given away a free kick. Jarvis will end up taking it for De La Salle. Into the side this week. Didn't play in the seniors last week. Left foot kick out to Pian Highway, side of the ground. Umpire didn't blow the whistle. Ball end up there with Fleming. High up and under kick inside the 45. Lynch at the back, could have marked. Fell to ground again. Ryan into an open goal and kicked it. They're on the board. They're on the way. Zavs score the first goal of the afternoon. Mercury, it was, I apologise, he's kicked the first goal into the first 2 minutes of this grand final and they're on their way. One goal straight, six. Delay yet to score. Mercury with the first goal of the game.
John Mercury, two possessions, he's a danger man, Ken.
Yes, well, I was just going to say the same thing. He almost set the other one up. It was made a bit of a mess of it up forward, but it certainly capitalised on the ball being hit out to him that time, Mercury.
Ruck contest, Nethersole went up for De La Salle, couldn't take the ball. Shields been great for De La this year, got a handball away, working hard, Josh Oakley. And once again, we'll get a result and restart. We have Sam Williams getting up a little bit tender in the centre of the ground for the De La Salle side. Zavs onto the board, they lead one straight to zero. 2.5 minutes gone. Cameron Purse gets the tap down. Looking for Andrew Bowen, playing up the ground. Ball comes down through David Lowe. Now Aaron Shields for De La Salle. Gets the handball away to Harrison. Harrison knocked off the ball. Lowe working hard. Going back, Brad Rogerson for Zavs. Gets the handball away to Purse, who goes to Darvell, who set up the first one. Was dispossessed. Umpire said play on. What a hard tackling applied by Harrison, and we'll get another resultant ball up, this time by umpire Davidson, right on centre wing, three gone first term.
It's a really good start to a grand final, this. It's just no holds barred early in the first couple of minutes.
No, they're going at it full pelt, that's for sure. Agius worked it out the back once again, another ball up, right on centre wing, right in front of us. We've gone 3 minutes in this first term for Sky High Mount Dandenong, and on the cover-up canvas product scoreboard, Zavs lead one straight to Delay, yet to score. Thumped out of the ruck, going through. Was Pickett without the football. Kick along the ground by Nick Roberts. Then went again. Ball still on centre wing, though, for De La Salle. They try to work it out through Harrison. Handball. Pickett ran straight into Clark. Had to rebound, go backwards. Found a teammate, Nick Roberts. Heard the call in the middle. Gave the kick to David Lowe. Had to get rid of it quick. He did a kick towards centre half forward. Mark taken by Mannix. He'll kick from about 43 metres out. In front, now he goes short into the woods. Hale, and he takes the mark about 40 metres out from goal at the scoreboard end for Dela.
Well, that was a great delivery by Lowe then. Beautiful kick into the forward line.
And Mannix picked up where he left off last week in the preliminary final. They're going to need him to present himself up forward to be a key player.
Hale in for the first shot of the afternoon for Dela's out of bounds on the full. And no score there to them. Gone 4 minutes in this first term of the grand final. Zavs lead the way. One straight goal, six. Delay yet to score.
Poor finish by the youngster there, Sam Hale, and the Young Player of the Year award went to this man, Nick Wing, from the Old Zavarians Football Club. He gets the penalty free kick. Kicks long, very, very wide, right out to the outer side. Nethersole went up against Purse. Nethersole did his own roving, got the handball away to Pickett. Fantastic in the preliminary final, setting up. Pickett drop punts right up to the half forward line. Lee Harrison knocked off the ball by Darvel, who takes it in the back pocket for Old Zavarians.
So inside the 45 metre arc, Nepean Highway side, he goes to Clark. A long way in front of Shields, wants to play on straight away. But now he holds up play in the brilliant sunshine here at Sports Cover Arena.
Ball.
A good kick. Mark taken here by Pickett. Goes in short for D-Larder Lowe. He takes the mark 55 out from goal. To the scoreboard, into the ground go D-Larder. Puts it high towards centre half. Four, they came out to meet it. No one could claim it. Nick Roberts has to go back. Aegis wins the footy easily. Kick away from him out towards Ryan. Will he meet the ball before the boundary line? He won't. Goes over the line out of play at half back for Old Zavs. Will have a ball in.
There's no room for errors like that in grand finals. We've seen two simple turnovers, a really poor shot for goal. You need to be on your game early.
Old Zavs feeling the pressure really does. Now Josh Aegeus, left foot across his body, up to half forward, and McCurry stands firm and takes the mark. Between wing and half forward, John McCurry, 3-on-3 up in the forward 45 arc. He kicks up towards, missing his target and his skipper Fleming. Ball comes to ground. Sam Williams had a great season. Gets the handball away to Davidson. Davidson went to close and close went out to open spaces. Leading out in the race for the ball there was Pickett for Dillard. He's on centre wing. He gets onto his left side up looking for Lee Harrison. He's got Andrew Bowen on him. At the back, Nick Wynn doing well. He'll probably get a handball away to Bowen. They're still under pressure, Old Zavs. They get the football and they swing it back towards the centre, and the mark has been dropped by Sapapo. Coming through hard with Serafini, and he'll clear.
So the Spruker works it out towards centre wing. Four Zavs out there towards Wynn. Will he get there just before Ben Oakley did? Fists it clear. Close picks up there for Dela. Handball. Close to the boundary line. Back to Ben Oakley. Back towards Hale. Goes back outside to Close. They worked it well, Dela. Worked a kick towards centre wing to Shields. He takes the mark. Heard the call from behind. Gave the handball. Another handball coming in to lower. He messed it up. Going in, Dynan over the top. Couldn't control it. Going in after it again. Clark. Handball to Serafini. Handball Aegis. Old Zavs work it from halfback. Kick up towards centre wing to Clark. He takes the mark on his chest. Ryan screaming for it at half forward. He goes to centre half forward, lead out from Fleming, handball back towards Clark. He can run to the arc here, he can dodge and weave. He tried to, now has to get rid of it with a handball. Goes back to Ryan, 50 out, centre half forward, the target Lynch, he's taken it in front of his eyes, and he'll go back and have a shot on goal here for Zavs at the Len Huntley Road end of the ground.
What great composure Clark showed in that piece of play. I mean, the other players would have panicked 10 times over. He was as cool as a cucumber, really did set the play up. Good delivery that time too from number 10, Andrew Ryan.
So directly in front, Lynch into an open goal. Doesn't miss those, does he? No, he doesn't. Two on the board to Zavs.
Ground Boys, level, just, Barnaby Willis.
Just down at ground level, barely a breeze. There's nothing. No breeze. Perfect conditions for footy.
Michael, just quickly, Zavs are working the ball laterally really well. DeLaSalle just can't find the ball into the corridor. And when Zavs go forward, they're hitting the hot spot right in the heart of the ground. And DeLaSalle are being forced to just work that wing, and they just can't get the ball too central enough to find key targets in the half forward area.
And as you said, they're turning over. Ben Corrin got the ball out of the ruck contest. And Louis Balzami doing the clearance stats this afternoon. A lot of them, I think when we have a listen to him at quarter time, a lot of them have been ineffective so far, because once again we're going to get a restart of play. Ruck contest. Sapapo now up for the Old Zavarian side. They get a quick takeaway up to the half forward line. Tim Fleming leads out. Gets the handball to the other veteran in Clark. Clark across his body up looking for Hanley. Punched away by Davidson. Ball comes to the pack. Fleming does the roving. Chris Smith kicks across his body far too far and over the line. Out of bounds on the full, and DeLaSalle will get the resultant penalty free kick, and going back will be Michael Davidson to take it.
Michael, already we're seeing a pattern of Zavs working the ball out of all these stoppages. It's happened several times, even at this early part of the game. When the game is closed up, it's Zavs that get the ball out.
Yep.
Davidson, a kick. Corrin goes up, tried to fist it away. He may have missed it anyway. It's gone over the back of the pack. And we'll have a ball in, 55 out from Zavs goal. Kicking with a slight breeze to the Glen Huntley Road end of Sports Cover Arena in this first quarter. We've gone nearly 10 minutes into it. Up they go. Sapapo wins it down. Ryan Lee stole it. Now has it. Now he does it. He lost it there to Close. Stacks on the mill develop and we'll have another ball up.
Ken, the important thing too, I think, is when Zabs has gone forward, they've almost had a live shot at goal nearly every time. D-Love had one poor shot which missed everything entirely, but they probably had enough inside 50s or as many as what Zabs have.
So Pupo gets it away to Matt Ball, who kicks up to Hanley in front. Punched away from him at the back. Now Chris Smith gets the football, goes backwards, looks for Darvell now from 55. It was Dynan. Dynan drove it long. And to the left and one minor score. So Altavarians, their first minor on a 2-1-13. They lead De La Salle, who are yet to score on the cover-up canvas product scoreboard. And the first term brought to you by the Sky High Restaurant on Mount Dandenong.
And Timothy Dynan's had a fair share of the ball in this quarter. I know he's a bit similar to look at as Darvell.
So ball to be kicked back in, 10 minutes gone. Ryan come off for Zavs and Prowse has come on for them after that shot on goal had missed before. So De La Salle with a lot of work to do. Williams with a kick, goes towards half, back up they go. Sopapo with the fisted punch, Ben Oakley picks up there for De La. Goes back with a handball, got it to low, got through Aegis, kicked towards centre wing. Bad bounce, eluded the Zavs. Eventually they get it through Wynn. A handball there, Dynan lost the footy, a throw. And the free kick going Pickett's way here for De La Salle inside the centre square. 11 minutes gone, first turn. They trail 13-0. Zavs have the lead. He goes in short, shocking kick. And it's been marked inside the 45-metre arc. Zavs have the footy. Kick back towards centre wing. 3-on-1. No one can take the mark. Ball hit the deck. So does Dynan. Puts it onto his left boot. Kick around the body. Fleming out in front. Has taken the mark on his chest. Turns quickly. Centre half forward. Handley the target. Can't mark. Ball! Oh, gee. That was a strong, hard knock there from Handley. He's collected Fenton. And he'll get himself up. Dust himself off. And receive a free kick. You could hear that from here.
De La Salle had three players. You caught it right, Simon. Had three players up in that contest there. There were two Zavs down to clear the ball away.
Yeah. Fenton goes very short to Close. Now they're being made to slow up play. This is not what they want. Close goes into Ben Oakley, who takes the mark for the De La Salle side. Still at half back. And they're yet to score. We've gone 12 minutes. Oakley just chipping short. Goes up there and finds his man in Maloney. Jared Maloney went up for Shields. Shields wasn't happy with the attention from Larkins. Umpire said it was a free against you, Chris Sparky. Larkins, and the free kick will go to Aaron Shields.
The winner of the best on ground last week.
Started well,
certainly was.
Started well again this week.
He has. On the overlapping handball, it goes back to Sam Williams. Old Zavs have got plenty on the ball or behind the ball. A big punch away, comes to ground. Sam Williams should be able to pick it up again and reload. He misses his target. He gets the ball back there to Jared Maloney. Maloney went back to Hale, and Hale drove it up forward, and the mark's been taken by Nick Roberts. 48 metres out, maybe too far out to score. If there is a breeze, he's kicking into it.
Shields should slide down the outside here and make himself dangerous inside
Nick
45.
Nick Roberts from the arc hasn't got the carry. Right up to the top of the goal square. Up they go. It's a mark to De La. Gompai called play on. Altavarians have got the ball. They're clear. Out looking for Prowse. Prowse and or Shields. Shields does very well. Chips back into the centre and finds his team marking Jake Gotch 40 metres out. No real angle to speak of. So Jake Gotch. No, he doesn't want to make the distance. That's a big giveaway here. He can't make the distance. So he's going to chip it in short and find his teammate in Josh Oakley.
He wouldn't have gained much meterage there, would he?
I wouldn't have thought so.
From where he's going to end up kicking it from?
Not
well,
from
obviously he nearly couldn't kick the 40.
Yeah.
So Josh Oakley will line up directly in front. 40 metres out. He's got the De La faithful behind him at the scoreboard end of Sports Cover Arena. 13 and a half minutes gone, first term of the A-section grand final. Oakley comes in, the drop punt's on its way. Has it got the carry? No. Ball taken away by Zavarians.
So they've got no one to kick it to, Don, and he had to go the handball, go back inside, found Matt Ball. Oh, Wynn! Collected there by Josh Oakley, good tackle, Wynn. Loose ball to Gotch. De La Salle's Nethersole from the boundary. Maddox in the square, will he go? He does. Ball didn't sit for him though. He had to wait for it to come back up to him. Now he's got support in Duggan. Mannix on the deck, into his back, free kick. Oh, he worked hard for that one. And directly in front of goal, he should slot it for them.
Gentlemen, there's definitely, I know Barnaby, you said there's no breeze, but a lot of those kicks are hanging up into that breeze.
There's the breeze now.
Going through Peter Curtin's microphone.
So an important kick here for Mannix to get them off to a fly, scoring goals anyway. Yet to score one. They trail 13-0. Mannix puts it on its way and kicked it. So they're on their way. Mannix kicks his first. May not be the last time we say that either. De La Salle kicked their first. They go into one straight six. Old Zavs on 2-1-13. 15 gone first term for Sky High Mount Dandenong.
Ken, just reading between the lines, I think it might be a very important match for Ben Mannix because I've got a feeling this might be his last.
Yes, I think you could be right. Could be right there, but, you know, things change, don't they? I mean, let's get to the end of the game and the result. That might have a bearing on the decision that's made.
In the centre, Sam Neversole up against David Sapapo, who does the Cameron Purse, who does the roving himself for Old Zavarians. Can't take it. Quick handball, Darvell. Ends up going back there now to Dimatina. Dimatina gets the handball to Serafini. Italian connection,
oh,
right
kick.
Up forward. Misses the target on this occasion. Jarvis working back. Gets the handball to Robin Close, who goes out wide. Very, very wide, and the mark's been taken out there by Fenton. Daniel Close, it wasn't it? Robin Close played cricket. Fenton got the ball away now. Out wide, looking for Neversole. He went further, right around the outer wing where Maloney of the Tom variety wrapped up in a tackle and will get a resultant ball up. Right on the outer side of Sports Cover Arena. 15 minutes gone. Zavs lead it 13-6.
It's very much dissimilar to last week. We had a lot of rotation dealing in the game. There hasn't been as much chopping and changing from interchange benches early.
Jared Maloney for Dilar worked the handball there to Pickett, who then gave it to Hale, who lost the football on hands and knees. Still they work it out now. Zav's defence work. Now a chance. Jared Maloney got it to Shields. Fisted it further forward to Fields end. Has one bounce. Runs to 45. God, top of the square. Drops short. Mark taken by Wynn. Plays on straight away. Got the kick in the nick of time. Purse couldn't control it. Dilar all over the football. They have to try and work it out, but there's no one there for them. Colbert broke a Hale tackle. Ball ended up in the hands of Dimatina. Then he lost it to Neversole. Tight stuff on the boundary line over there, and we'll have a ball up. It's on the outer side of the ground, right on the 45-metre arc.
There are two number twos out there for Dilar at the moment. Someone's lost a number preceding that number two. So it's either Field, Sen or Vickers.
Okay. Thanks for that. Thrown in the air, Shields fisses it forward, up towards the pocket, backing back is Serafini, and Harrison saw him over the line. They look for deliberate, not there. We'll have a ball in, 25 out from the Dilar goal, attacking to the scoreboard end in this first term.
I think Fields might have just come off a low, so it might be Vickers.
Restart of play, ends up with Aaron Shields, can't take the ball. He gets a handball, Zavs get a handball away. They say deliberate, and they've called deliberate.
Well, they'll want to pay those for the rest
throw,
of the afternoon.
And the free kick will go back here to Aaron Shields. He'll kick from 35 metres out. I don't know what the free was for.
They need this goal to reward their entries inside 45 in the first quarter because they've been in as often as what Zavs have and struggled to score for the first 5 or 8 minutes. This will get them back on track nicely.
Good player, Aaron Shields. Won best on ground from us last week on the left foot. Drop punt going up towards the top of the goal square. Once again, hasn't got the carry. And the ball's called play on right at the top of the goal square. No one can take control. Pickett had his kick dispossessed. Shields dived on top of it. And we'll get a ball up. I still think that ball's just hanging up into that slight breeze going to the southern end in the first turn.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt that it's hanging up. No doubt at all.
13 play six. Zavarians have it. 18 minutes gone, first term. Huge pack of players. Zavs get a quick kick away. Right up towards half-back flank. Tim Clark in front. Dispossessed by Close. Dilar still have the numbers at ground level. One of them, Sam Williams. Pushed off the ball by Prowse. Ball comes back to Fenton. He's run over the line in front of the Xavier interchange. And we'll have a throw in. 18 and a half gone on the first term for the Sky High of Mount Dandenong. It's Zavs by seven.
13 playing six. 55 out from Dilar's goal. Brilliant sunshine at Sports Cover Arena down here today. Neversole won the tap. Nick Roberts went without it. Mercury didn't. Put it onto his boot. High kick, centre wing. Up they go. No one can take the mark. Hanley stayed down. So did Clark. He's got support there in Nick Smith. Chris Smith, now he goes in short to Fleming. Picked it up on the half volley. Handball to Ryan. In trouble back to Fleming. Handball out wide. Missed the target. Tom Maloney ended up with it. Now Fenton in trouble. Clark nearly had him. Back to Davidson. Umpire's blown the whistle.
He should have gone all the way, Clark, with that shot on goal. He had plenty of space in front of him. Not a lot of voice, I don't think.
Fenton with the free kick into the middle of the ground, and Lowe holds onto the mark. Middle of the ground, plays on straight away. Kick centre half forward to Harrison, fisted away there by Bowen, who ends up with it again. Kicked a short one, found his teammates Chris Smith, who finds Dynan, who goes in towards half forward. Good pick up Hanley, got rid of it quickly to Lynch, screaming for it Fleming. Lynch ignored that, goes for goal and misses everything. Gone over the line, out of play, will have the resultant free kick going Dilar's way.
Ken, Zavs look a little bit more deliberate and purposeful going forward, don't they?
Yes, well, I like the way they're backing one another up. The delivery hasn't been great at this stage to their players.
Well, Tim Clark mucked that one up. He got to 40. He's a beautiful finisher. I think he tried to be a bit cute. Now, Fenton's under pressure. This is exactly what Dilar don't want. He goes to close. He chips right up along the line, finding Aaron Shields. They're doing 15-metre kicks. There's a free kick down the field. Umpire McIntosh not happy, and the free kick will go
up the ground.
Up the ground. One of those ones no one's got any idea what for, why, how. And anyway, it'll go to Tim Clark right on the 45-metre arc.
Should have a shot.
Testing me. 1, 2, 3. Boys.
Yeah.
You just drag him to the ground behind play. And that is Fields sin. He's the bloke with the number one missing on his back.
So he Clark went up looking for Fleming, dispossessed. Came back to Oakley now. Oakley to Jarvis. Jarvis on the left foot. Ben Mannix held definitely in the contest. Umpire didn't see it that way. Nick Roberts working hard for Zavs. So was Nick Roberts for Dilar. So was Wynn for Zavs. Ended up with Agius. Everyone behind the ball. Another free kick.
Run too far.
This time it'll go to the way of Dilar Sell. And it'll go to Sam Pickett, who'll take the free kick and centre wing for De La Salle.
So he ran too far there, Agius, for Zavs. Gave away a free kick. Pickett goes towards Jared Maloney, takes the mark. Still a long way from home, in towards the 45 arc over Harrison's head. Backing up, though, were Zavs and Bowen. Works the kick to centre wing to Agius. Reeled it in with one hand, then went to go. But Pickett said he's not going any further than
me. He went.
Of course he did. He wanted to. Left foot kick to half forward, out in front. Fleming should
great
take
mark.
The mark. Three good marks for him in this first turn. They've all been beauties. Goes in towards centre half forward. Hanley backing back. Yes.
Yep.
Has taken the mark.
Done.
Goal to play on. Another pair of hands was on that ball. The umpire says, give it to me, I'll ball it up.
He said Dilar had first hands, I think.
Yes, I think you're right.
Thrown in the air. 30 out from Zav's goal. Fished away by Davidson towards the boundary line. Close goes to ground. Umpire says you got a free kick. He'll get up and take it deep in the back pocket here for Dilar at the Glen Huntley Road end. 13 playing 6. Zavs have the lead. 22 gone first turn.
The only thing that worries me with three umpires, I reckon they've got to pay more free kicks. Close tries to switch the ball and he does. Back into the full back position and out there was Davidson. Goes very wide to Fenton. Back pocket, but De La Salle still not getting that kamikaze style run going that we want to see. They're being held up by old Zavarians. Chips in very short too on that occasion. Jarvis, who gets the handball away to close, goes up the line looking for Gotch. Gotch drops what he should have taken. Now he looks for the boundary line and finds it. So half back flank for De La Salle. They've had the last six possessions and they still haven't got it out of their back line.
Well, I think both back lines are well and truly on top. I mean, that's the way that's gone. But that's good for Dilar.
Thrown in, Sapapo down to Dimitina. Kick along the ground. Finally, they go inside 45. Close, couldn't read that one properly. Jarvis backing him up for Dilar. Has the football, the handball. Wasn't a good one. Put Hale under pressure inside the defensive 45. And we'll have a ball up Nepean Highway side of the ground. Thrown in. Here's the Papo late on the scene. Corrin got the fisted punch though. Handball Dimitina along the ground. Didn't help out Colbert. Kick away there by Dynan. Going in now is Lowe. Pick it over the top. And on the 45 arc for Zavs, we'll have a ball up. 13 playing 6. 23 and a half gone first term.
It's a really intriguing game now at the moment because both sides are playing well through the midfield, but I just reckon Old Zav's just using the ball better going forward.
And Old Zav's get it again through Ryan Colbert right up to the top of the goal square. Hanley in front had the ball taken out of his hands. And once again, we'll have another stoppage. This time only 18, 20 metres out from the Old Zavarians goal. They're kicking to the northern or Glen Huntley Road end in front of a very, very good crowd here this afternoon at Elstonwick Park. Doing the roving Chris Smith. He was dispossessed. And once again, we'll have a throw-up 25 metres out from Old Zaverian's goal.
There's not one player in the forward half here for De La Salle.
Don't know if I like that. Free kick, and this time it'll go the way of Old Zaverian's out of that ruck contest. It'll go to Luke Howard. No, it'll go against Vickers.
Yeah.
It'll go to Luke Howard, I think.
Yeah, Luke Howard's right.
And Luke Howard will take the kick from 25 metres out. 45 degree angle. Usually a pretty good finisher.
There's actually only seven players outside the 45 arc for Old
Howard Jones. Comes in and pushes it hopelessly right. Out of bounds on the full. 13, two goals, one Old Zaverians, one straight six, De La Salle on the cover-up canvas product scoreboard.
Wasted opportunity, that one.
They can't do De La any favours going forward on a quick break here, can they?
No, cannot. No, there's so many players up chasing kicks here at the moment. Open it up a bit, we might get a better game on our hands. So Popo just fists it over the boundary line.
Another free kick there.
And we'll have a free kick going De La's way.
Mannix.
And Ben to take it down there at half back. So he's run up the ground looking for a kick himself. He goes to centre wing. Found Pickett, who takes the mark on his chest. Still a long way from home. Nepean Highway side of the ground. 25 and a half gone first term. Won't be a very long quarter. He comes back dangerously to Hale, who couldn't complete the mark. Zavs are in the hunt here. He goes towards the boundary line deliberately. Surely you've got to pay that, and he doesn't.
That turnover there by De La Salle was purely because of the fact that no one pushed back. They had one player forward of the centre circle then.
Thrown in again. Hanley just bumped Corrin out the way. Fist forward by De La to Dimatina, who worked it back. Now Serafini got around Vickers okay. Has to do it again. Now puts it onto the boot. Kicking towards half forward. Mercury up. Can't mark it. The deck hard though. Zav still have the ball here. Handball to Chris Smith, who then ran out of play. Deep in the right forward pocket for Zavza. We'll have another ball in.
One thing we have had, stoppages, throw-ins and ball-ups.
13 playing 6. Zavs have the lead inside their 45 arc. Hanley and Corrin go at it. So does Lowe. Fists it down and a free kick coming Zav's way. And Ball will take it on the outer side of the ground.
So Matt Ball, about 50 metres out. Had an injury interrupted year, just coming back to some form. For the Old Zaverian side, he goes up looking for Chris Smith, and he stands firm, the young man. And he'll kick from 30 metres out on a pretty acute angle in front of the Jumping Castle at the Glen Huntley Road end of the Elsternwick Hotel end of Sports Cover Arena, deep in that forward pocket.
Plenty of daylight down there too. He'll have the breeze into his face at that end. Only a slight one though, so...
Ball's been pushed across from that pocket a couple of times.
So here comes Chris Smith in.
Not a
goal.
Bad kick.
Damien Lynch went the early crow, put his hands up. Was pretty excited by it, hitting that right-hand goalpost. 2-2, 14 Old Zaverians. One straight six, De La Salle, 27 and a half gone, first term.
De La Salle are using a few players off the bench now, but they're only staying off the ground for about 2 minutes, which is really not long enough to be able to recover properly.
So Mannix from the kick in takes the mark. He's down at half back. He had a shot on goal for them and kicked their only goal of the first term 10 minutes ago and puts it out of play.
Poor kick.
So a shocking kick there by De La. Clark ends up with the footy. Now Fleming in the square. Clark gets around.
Kicked the goal.
Jarvis easily
coming
puts
back.
It on its way. Will it come back enough? No. Mannix has taken the mark in the last line. For De La, works it out towards Jared Maloney. Takes the mark, handball to close. Handball to Fenton. Gets outside defensive 45. Nepean Highway side breaks back to Davidson. Mark centre half back. Looks for someone running past. It's Corrin. Gets around Wynn. Through the middle. Kick smothered in the end. Found Sapapo. Handball back into the centre square to Serafini. Zavs go forward again.
Kick
to centre half forward.
Whoa!
And Mannix over the top of him. He's taken a beauty on the siren. Quarter time.
And on the siren at the 28 and a half minute mark, Ben Mannix took what was definitely the highlight of the quarter. Great grab right over the top and effectively stopped that Old Zaverian's foray forward. Quarter time in the 2009 VAFA A Section Grand Final. De La Salle 2-2 14. Sorry, Old Zaverian's 2-2 14. Lead De La Salle 1 straight 6. For Old Zavarians, the goal kickers are Damien Lynch and John McCurry. For De La Salle, the single goal kicker is Ben Mannix. And so far, the mark of the day also is to Ben Mannix.
Not didn't sound so excited that time, did he?
Australia's greatest lip reader, Barnaby Willis, there, here on 96.5 NRFM Football.
Can I just make a little prophecy about a player? I think Hanley's had his hands on the ball many times. He may just explode at any time.
Leading goal kicker for the competition.
Second term underway for Courtney and Patterson Honda. There's only 8 points in it. Old Zavs have the lead, and Ken D. La get back in front in this second term. It's about to all happen in front of our eyes here, and there's a really good crowd in attendance at Sports Cover Arena today. Gotch got it to close, smothered kick off the boot. Shields read it okay, brought to ground there by Howard. In the middle of the ground, it will have a ball up. 30 seconds gone, second term.
The most nervous guy on the ground will be the goal umpire to which De La Salle are kicking, because the cheer squad's moving end-to-end.
They go from end-to-end.
Oh, it's terrific to watch too. And
they're close to him too, so if he makes a blue, he'll know about it.
Back in the centre circle, we haven't gone too far. Ball thrown in the air again. Purse got it out the back. Tim Clark, a missed kick. Held up there by Vickers. Once again inside the centre square, 5 metres towards Zav's goal, will have another ball up.
So when we're saying clearances here a lot of the time to Zavs, they might be clearing, but they're only going 5 metres, aren't they?
Yeah.
Now, Tim Clark, he gets a kick away along the ground. Ryan does the shepherding, comes back to Josh Agius. Wrapped up well by Hale in a tackle. Clark, first of the ball, can he keep it in? He can. He elects to give the handball back to Andy Ryan. Gets the ball back on this occasion, looking for Darvell, can't take control. Jake Gotch gets it over to Close. On the overlap, looks for Jarvis for Dealer. Back to Shields.
Ooh.
Ball goes over the line out of bounds. There's no easy possessions here in the VAFA 2009 Grand Final. Zavs have it 2-2 to 1 straight. Throw in 65 metres around from the Old Zavarians goal. Kicking to the southern end. Tim Clark wrapped up in a tackle on that occasion by Jared Maloney. And we'll have a ball up 65 metres out from the Old Zavs goal.
Sam Williams has come back on the ground.
Yeah, Vickers has just gone off. 14 playing 6.
I hope that wasn't the gin you're talking about. It's not a bad gin, Vickers.
No, well, he's come off and he might... you never know, do you, Kim? You just never know what might set these players alight. Different things. Clark goes in with a shocking kick. He's hit William Zilly in the chest. He couldn't complete the mark. Ball spills to Colbert. 45 out. Squares it towards Lynch. Can't get there in the nick of time. Jarvis did. Now a chance here for Close. A handball over the top here to Nick Roberts. Stolen in the end here by Howard. Spins on a strip and he delivers back inside to Colbert. And he's marked it on the chest as he's gone down to ground.
Well, it looked very much as though Zavs were very keen each time there to get the ball into that main centre forward position, centre half forward. What we used to call the hotspot a few years ago.
I reckon Ryan Colbert's one of the X factors of this sort of game too.
Oh, absolutely.
Comes in and out of play nicely, but doesn't dominate.
When he's in the
play, very handy.
He's very good.
Yep. Looking for Zav's third goal of the afternoon. Into a slight breeze at the scoreboard end of the ground. Puts it on its way and kicked it. Yes, he has.
He's also a very good kick for goal.
Kevin Sagoda puts up the two arms there. We'll wave the flags and tell us that old Zavs have kicked their third. 3-2, 20 to 1 straight, 6 dealer. We have gone 3 minutes for Courtney Patterson Honda, and that scoreboard to us by Fine Fruits of Eltham.
He's a bit hard to pick up, Colbert, without the the sleeveless Guernsey. I mean, he hasn't got the biggest arms in the business. Side on almost disappeared then.
Middle of the ground, near the sole up against Purse. Purse gets the takeaway as far there as Darvell, wrapped up in
a
tackle. And I don't even know why we have the first ball up here today, because they just always have the second one. They should just tell them it's the second one.
Well, it's like taking the last jump away.
Exactly.
Hand on
I agree with that.
Yeah.
Cameron Purse will get the free kick.
There'll always be a last jump. So
that's
there'll always
right.
be another ball up.
Cameron Purse now unloads four Old Zavarians up to the half forward line. Smith in front. Can't take the mark. Working De La Salle at the back of the pack. They can't do so. Ryan for Old Zavarians, the little man, trying to get onto his right-hand side. Gets the ball back there to Chris Smith. Now Ryan Colbert just goes for the boundary line. De La applying pressure, Ken and Andrew, but they just really can't get the ball at the moment.
Yes, well, they've been pretty good. Look, it's a great contest, really. Let's face it, they're both hard at it.
They've got to keep applying scoreboard pressure, otherwise they'll be blown out of the water.
20 play 6, Howard, handball to Tim Clark. Now he wants to load up, or he goes much shorter, and now he goes to Chris Smith. Between wing and half forward, Smith up to the leading hand, Lee in front, but he's too far out to score. Still 60 metres out. D-Lar will be happy for him to get the ball there. He kicks the ball right up towards the full forward line, but Sam Williams drops back and takes the resultant mark for D-Lar.
Yep.
Shields is looking a bit proper in the middle of the ground. He just got a knock to the leg, so we'll keep an eye on him.
Righto, so Williams has the foot. He doesn't know where to go. He goes towards Davidson right on the boundary line inside the arc and hits him.
I reckon that's nearly gone backwards, that ball.
Yeah, just about. Scoreboard in. They trial by 14 points. Davidson across the face of goal. All the way across the face, he found Jarvis, who pops it over the top to Hale. Away he can go with a bounce outside 45. Does just that. Delivers a kick to centre wing. Over the head. No, gotcha. Oh, he held onto it. Good mark in the end. He was doubling back, but he reeled it in. Gala handball there to Jared Muller, to Duggan. Duggan goes towards half forward. Mark taken by Harrison. No. Backing up, Bowen just charges his way through half back, delivers towards Fleming,
and
he takes his fourth good mark of the afternoon, right on the point of the centre square. Handball to Clark, 50 out from goal to Handley, and hits him on the chest 40 metres out.
He's just come off Aaron Shields and looks very, very proper. I don't think he's going to probably see the rest of the game out.
Well, we can scratch him off the list.
Sorry, Ken.
How about that for delivery?
Great delivery, and fantastic. All the big names from Old Zaverians came out to play in that passage of play with Bowen to Fleming.
It was all the passage of play that you can tell is made by the side who's dominated the competition from round one onwards.
It was made by Fleming. That was another good, strong front mark. It was a terrific mark. Handley, the sharpest shooter in A grade this year. Have a look at that. He's put it on its way and kicked another one. That's their fourth. Oh dear, it's not Moomba already, is it? 4-2-26, Zavs. D-Lar on one straight six. Six and a half gone. Second turn. That on the Fine Fruits of Eltham scoreboard for Courtney Patterson. Onto six and a half gone. Second turn.
Moomba?
Well, could it be a procession?
Gotcha.
Thank you. You were well ahead of all of us who had no idea what you were talking about whatsoever. So thanks for explaining
that.
Okay. Peirce gets the ball out of the centre for Old Zaverians. D-Lar, they need to win a clearance. They're nearly going to do so. Hale up and under kick, but only as far as Serafini. So Zavs will take the ball away out wide to Agius. Half forward flank for Old Zaverians. They've kicked the last couple. They've doubled their quarter time lead. Agius driving in very well, finds Luke Howard, who takes the mark 40 metres out, and he'll just chip the ball up, dangerously looking for Chris Smith. He probably should have gone for goal. Came down to Fenton. Now De La Salle, they'll try and clear. Will they be able to clear? Hale went back to Davidson, wrapped up in a tackle. Fields then, umpire said holding the ball, and De La Salle just panicking at the moment.
Yeah, very indecisive play there from about three or four possessions then.
And the free kick will go back to the dangerous forward in John Mercury. And he'll kick from 15 metres out, point blank range. And this to bring the lead out to 26 points. So getting a little bit dangerous now. Mercury comes in, puts it on his boot and puts through Old Zaverian's fifth goal into 5-2. 32, De La Salle, one straight six. 8 minutes gone in the second term. That scoreboard brought to you by the Fine Fruits of Eltham.
Well, I would think that in the 8 minutes that we've seen of this quarter, there's been a complete turnabout in the disposal of the ball by hand or by foot by Zavs. I mean, they were a bit shaky in that, weren't they, Andrew, in the early part? Been excellent in this.
The key thing is they're only 8 minutes into the second quarter. They've got to get back to playing how they started and their structure and strategy at the start of the game. D-Lussell.
Thrown in the air again. Peirce got it down to Darvell, who was grabbed there by Gotch. He never threw him into the deck, though. That's what he had to do. He just stood up and took hold of him. That's no good for any inspirational tackling for D-Lar at the moment. Throw him into the deck and make him hurt. Now over the top, Duggan. Handball, Nick Roberts.
Like
thrown
that
out of the pack there for D-Lar was Hale, and he'll get a free kick. They need to show something to their supporters and to themselves. Hale, handball Duggan. High, long kick. Top of the square. Manage going back. Won't get there. Now he does. Off the ground. Misses. Things not going their way at the moment. Minor score to D-Lar.
Just a little thing then. Manic's led, and I was watching the play. The two players the player who had the ball, handball to a running player, and Manic had already taken off, and neither player was looking at the lead.
Bowen about to bring the ball back in for Old Zaverians. Kicks it long down the centre of the ground. Zavs have the numbers up. Mannix was the dive to ground. Was he taken high? No, said umpire Sutcliffe. and we'll have a result and throw up 55 metres around from the Dealer goal. They need the next one. Ruck contest. Mannix third man up. Tried to get it down to Low. Low wrapped up in a tackle. Old Zav's putting pressure on. Dealer just can't break free.
He might have been third man up. He was nowhere near that. If you're going to be third man up, you hit it.
Well, he missed it on that occasion. Now came down to Gotch for DeLarcel. And guess what? We're going to have another ball up and we've gone nowhere.
De La Salle aren't influencing enough contests. They're getting players there, but they're actually not winning them or halving them.
Thrown up, Purse fisted out towards Clark, held up slightly there by Nick Roberts, who then ended up with the footy. Ball on the deck again, 50 out from De La's goal. At the Glen Huntley Road end of the ground, will have another ball up. Or a blood rule. What's it going to be? No, Sutcliffe is going to do something here. Hello.
Yeah, I think there's blood coming from the nose of Hale.
There is too. So why isn't he going off? He had a look at him. There is blood there. Thrown in the air again. No one won the tap. Down towards Nick Roberts. Lost the football to the deck. Going in after it again. He kicked it off the ground. Jared Maloney handball out wide over the boundary line. Low made sure that Ball knew he was in a contest just for a little while there. Hale now being squirted by the female trainer.
That's just going to make the blood run down his chin, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. Up they go again. Pickett to the front of the pack. Tim Clark there. Colbert. Now Dynan goes through into his back. Jared Maloney. Loose footy here. Zav's in trouble. Dealer trying to win the football out somehow. Mannix ended up with it and tried to kick. On ground level. He's good. He's not that good. He couldn't clear that. We're 40 out from goal.
At ground level, Barnaby Peter. Any news on Aaron Shields?
Very proppy.
Thank you, Barnaby. Now, coming back was Wynn for the old Zavarians team. He goes up looking for Rogerson, can't take the mark. And once again, the ball's over the line and out of bounds. We're incisive. Playing on old Zavarians terms at the moment.
That's the beauty of having Barnaby down there. That's incisive.
And succinct.
You know, that's 5-2-32
to 1-1-7. 45 metres around from the De La Salle goal. Kicking to the Glen Huntley Road end. They've got a lot of support. But they need to get their supporters up and firing. They need a couple of goals and they need them quickly. You just feel as though a second semi-final replay coming up at the moment. Clark across his body. Down towards centre wing position. Run over the line by Nethersole, who's working tirelessly. Virtually single ruckman today. Yeah, they're using Ben Corran as his assistant. Nethersole goes off the ground. Corran now will contest against Purse. Centre wing position. Purse wraps him up, comes down to Tim Clark. Diving on the ball was Howard. Ryan Colbert, pile driven into the ground. Can De La Salle get it free? They can't. Agius tries to break free. Goes up to the half forward line. Working back there, De La Salle. They do have the numbers. One of them's Williams.
Well,
dispossessed by the youngster and Esmond Prowse. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. Free kick, Tim Fleming. No set umpire, Davidson. Will have a throw in. It's Old Zavs by 25. 12 minutes gone, second term for Courtney and Patterson.
Great play from Esmond Prowse in that little pass. It won't feature in the stats, but pressure the player all the way then.
That's all they need to do, isn't it? Corran out the back, fisted it as far as he possibly could. Clark in the van in front, then met Corran. Chance there, Vickers back on the ground. Handball close, put him under pressure. Umpire's blown the whistle, free kick going his way against Agius. For a push.
Throw. Put down after the tackle.
Rightio.
Yeah, after the tackle.
Well, there you go. Lux of fortune. Close has got the footy. Deep in defence at the scoreboard end of Sports Cover Arena, a long way from home. Gave the handball off.
Fields in
a handball to Davidson. Picked it up in the nick of time. Handball inside. They can raffle it. Corran. Handball back. Oh, gee. Fields end was there, but he didn't go. Along the ground, Jared Maloney to close. Ran straight into a sea of old Zavarians. Going nowhere. Ball up centre wing. 32 playing 7. 13 and a half gone. That on the fine fruits of Eltham scoreboard for Courtney Patterson Onda. Now Tim Clark. Centre wing.
Been good,
onto the boot. Yeah, sure has. Kick up towards Fleming at half forward. 50 out from goal. Squares it up towards McCurry. Oh, he's taken a run. It was. Another he didn't take the mark. It came out the back here towards Lynch. Picks it up over the shoulder. Yes. No. Just to the left of these. Padding on the goal post and only a minor score. 33 playing 7. Old Zavs have the lead. That on the fine fruits of Eltham scoreboard. We've gone 14 for Courtney Patterson Honda.
I saw about four or five handballs by De La Salle players in that last little piece, and you wouldn't want to be on the end of any
Always
one of
under
them.
The pump at the moment. Now, the designated kick in, Matt Fields' end. goes to his co-Woodrow medalist in David Lowe, the skipper, and now we'll get a resultant 25-metre penalty. This is where they're breaking down through the centre of the ground. Chips in, dangerously short, but finds Ben Corran. Played most of the year up forward. Being used as a second ruckman with Kelleher out injured. Corran goes very wide, out to the outer side. Half forward flank, Duggan in his 200th game. Danger man, the ball comes back to Pickett. Does very well, backs it back to Jake Gotch. Back there to Pickett. Pickett to Lowe, who's run the length of the ground and takes the mark. Right on 45. Come on, skipper, the D-La need a goal. 45 metres out, 5-3 to 1-1. He's going back a lot more confident than some of his teammates were in the first term. He'll kick from the arc.
Got to kick.
David Lowe comes in and kicks straight into the man on the mark in Matt Ball. Now Jake Gotch is at the bottom of the pack. He gets the handball back to Ben Corran. Corran goes wide, out looking for Vickers. Wider again, dropping the mark. Nick Roberts coming through with Sparky Larkins. He got the handball away to McCurry and he went to Esmond Prowse.
So Prowse towards the boundary line. It may go over, it may be allowed to go over before Chris Smith could actually reel it in. And it does. Centre wing, 33 playing 7. Zavs have the lead. 15 and a half gone in this second term. So Papo won the tap from the throw in. Vickers a good pickup. Nick Roberts lost it though. Aegeus, well done. Handball there, Darvell. Found Serafini. A kick towards centre wing. Jared Maloney got it up to Corran, who goes back to Shields, who's come back onto the ground. He runs to 50. Goes to Mannix on the chest and can't complete the mark. And Zavs will work it out of defence. Bowen a kick up here towards Dynan. Will he trap it? He does. High tackle on him. Free kick downfield. Prowse, has it paid advantage? No.
No, he's going back.
It'll come back. And
how good was that spoil from Wynn then?
Terrific.
He's a good player.
Fantastic.
Dynan ends up with the footy. Kick towards centre wing. Outer side of the ground. Hits Howard on the chest for Zavs. And the Pean Highway side of the ground. They lead 33-7. We've gone 16 and a half in this second term. Howard, long as he possibly can. Underneath it there, DiMartino, has he brought it down? Yes, he did, but it hit the deck as well. Umpire says, give it to me, I'll ball this one up inside 45.
Aaron Shields has come back on the ground. He looks very, 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 very much improved from the injury we saw him take. He's a very important player to this side.
Barnaby and Peter Zavs, are they ringing more changes than D-La?
No, both sides ringing the changes fairly evenly. Shields definitely a lot better, but he wasn't very happy at all when he came off before.
Well, he probably won't be because the score says Old Zavarians 33, D-La sells 7. It's 5-3 to 1-1. 17 minutes gone for Courtney and Patterson in the second term. Restart of play with 35 metres out from the Old Zavarians goal. Michael Darvell goes bang. Just looking very, very ominous at the moment for the De La Salle Football Club this afternoon. Old Zavarians on a 6-3-39. Darvell kicks his first. They've just got so much firepower up for De La Salle. 1-1-7 for the fine fruits of Eltham scoreboard.
Can you just can't afford to waste entries inside the 45-metre arc, and that's what De La Salle are doing. They're getting the ball in there. That kick from Shields to the leading forward earlier was brilliant. Got spoiled away. But you've got to get more bang for your buck when you go inside.
Thrown in the air, so Papo won it down. Gotch steals it. Handball there, not a good one by Hale. Now going in Clark. Fists it forward, then it was held up there by Gotch again. They work it in the middle of the ground and Zavs work it towards their goal by 20 metres.
I think what's happening, Andrew, is again, and we've said it plenty of times, Zavs are making them play the game at their pace.
Yep, correct.
Just slow them down all the time.
Thrown in the air. Corran got that one down. Williams, a high tackle twice. No, not paid. Close goes in. He got crunched. Handball there from Ball. Goes backwards to Bowen. Hale ends up with it there for De-La. Going through Shields, went without it. Goes in after it again to right or wrong. He can't work it out because Bowen's all over him. And we'll have another ball up 5 metres towards De-La's goal from the centre circle.
The message I'd been sending out, Simon, from the coach's box here would be, this is the last game of the year. You leave nothing in reserve to win this game of football because it's a grand final.
Absolutely. Corran, once again, won the tap down, but he hasn't got much support around him. And we'll have another ball up as Dynan tries to work it out. We are still 5 metres ahead of the centre circle towards De-La's goal.
Huge pack of players. Ben Corran working hard, but once again, we're going absolutely nowhere. And as Ken and Andrew have stated numerous times this afternoon, this is suiting old Zverians. This is the way they want to get the game going, and there's just no clear takeaways at all. Old Zverians get a kick out of mid-air down towards Lee Harrison. He pushed off his man there, Chris Smith. Falling over was Oakley there for De La Salle. Zavs have it again up towards the dangerous McCurry. Picks it up beautifully on the half volley off his shoelaces. Up looking for Ryan, deep in the forward pocket. Gets the ball back. They bomb it high right up to the top of the goal square. Duggan pushed off. The umpire said no free kick. Lynch came flying through. De La Salle will clear on this occasion. It goes out to Fields' end. Fields in, out there now to Vickers on the left foot. Comes back in towards the centre, looking for the 200 gamer in Michael Duggan. Takes the mark. This is a better build-up. Goes to Lee Harrison. Lee Harrison, two on two. Mannix at the back, can't take the mark. He keeps his feet. Ball comes to ground. Wrapped up Nick Roberts in a tackle. Came back to Ben Mannix. Ben Mannix went back to Vickers. Vickers got the handball away. On to Pickett. Pickett kicked it up to the top of the goal square. And at least they've scored a rush behind. 1-2-8 De La Salle. 6-3-39 Old Zverians, 20 gone, second term, scoreboard for the Fine Fruits of Eltham.
And again, no panic from Zavs in a tight situation, no. Then just good defensive football.
So Bowen to kick the ball back in, goes as long as he can outside the 45. Aegeus up, oh, as he brought it down, nearly dead in the end anyway. Williams a handball, Shields under pressure, ball on the deck. Corrin gets it up, Harrison volleyball stuff there towards Williams. Back to Jared Maloney, now goes back to Harrison. Harrison onto Williams, he can run and have a shot. He's got to have a shot and kick it, and he misses. To the left of the goalpost. 8-9, 39. 30 points the margin. Zavs have the lead. That on the Fine Fruits of Eltham scoreboard. 21 gone for Courtney and Patterson on to second term. At least he needed to kick that.
At least
for
they're
spark.
Starting to at least run the football through the lines, because they so far haven't.
But if you're going to get all those shots to go from that position, they're going to struggle as well. You've got to get the ball inside the corridor and give your forwards the best chance to get easy shot to goal.
Andrew Bowen went very, very short to Matt Ball, who picked the ball up off virtually off the grass.
Yeah, just in the nick.
He's been paid a mark deep in the back pocket. So Matthew Ball going to the outer side of the ground. Sapapo up in front. Knocked away from him, out of bounds, right in front of the jumping castle.
Huge amount of people over there too in front of that jumping castle. They've all come out to look at the game.
Restart of play, 50 metres around from the De La Salle goal. As Simon said, they desperately need one just to get some momentum going. Ben Corrin wrapped up in a tackle. And umpire Davidson will throw it up 55 metres out.
And we've seen it 100 times before in various forms of the game, various levels, but it's not hard to get yourself back in the game with two or three quick goals and put some pressure on the leading side.
Just at the moment, Andrew and Ken, they just don't look like they're going to get those two or three goals.
Well, they're not being allowed to play the game that they like to play. I think that's the secret to it. They close the game up beautifully.
Yeah, Ken, all their better players from last week in the prelim final that we saw are down today.
50 out from Dillard's goal. Harrison tried to steal it, couldn't do it. Handball over the top there from Howard towards the boundary line. Ryan there, great tackle on Williams. Umpire said play on. Clarkley upended his opponent. Kick up here towards Pickett, who saw it over the boundary line. Will have a ball in. 50 out from Dillard's goal.
Every time Dillard go forward, their forward line players are under pressure because of the disciplined defensive nature of old Zavs. They just play it to the book.
Thrown back in again. Dining goes to ground. Chance Shields goes to centre half forward, but win a long way in front of Mannix. Has taken the mark on his chest. Mannix playing from behind. Win goes towards Rogerson, who marks it half back. Chips it back inside towards Ryan, who takes the mark. Telling him to come up to him. He goes in short. Not a good kick in the end towards the boundary line. McCurry under pressure. Handball in front of himself. Dimatina there, now Fields in. Tackled well by McCurry, got the handball in the nick of time. Finds close at halfback, running through the middle, a handball to Harrison. Handball inside here to Hale. Away they go towards the outer side of the ground. Mark taken by Fenton before Aegeus can get there, 50 out from goal. Looks at the top of the square. He goes towards Vickers and he takes the mark. 35 metres out from goal. On an angle, but directly, virtually on an angle at the Glen Utley Road end of the ground.
Hasn't been the worst player, Vickers, so he's managed to get his fair share of the ball.
Fields then starting to come into it too now, and he was a good player last week.
He's got great balance.
Yeah.
Shields is back off the ground. Corrin's come off as well.
Not as properly as last time, though, Shields.
Gotch is off as well. As going into goal there is Vickers, and he's kicked their second. So Dillard kicked their second. They go on to 2-3-15. Zavs on 6-3-39. That on the 24 minute mark of the time clock, that on the Fine Fruits of Eltham scoreboard.
Taken a long time to kick two goals, hasn't it, with a quarter and almost the second quarter almost gone as well.
But the way they got it is the way they said they were going to have to play to score. They just had to run and get forward of the ball and just keep running. And it worked on that occasion. I still think they've probably got a little bit left in the tank. If they don't let Oldsmobile get any further out, they can still run on here. Sam Nethersole up against Purse. Nethersole headed it on that occasion. It came down. Quick handball away to Bowen, who went to Darville, who kicked the last goal for Oldsabs. Up towards the half forward line, leading out Chris Smith. Can't take control. Purse will now get wrapped up in a tackle. And once again, we'll have a ball up. Just the commentary side of centre circle here at Elstonwick Park. Umpire McIntosh puts it up in the air. Nethersole had a fresh air with hand and foot. The ball came to ground. De La Celle getting a bit more of the footy. Fenton, they're still under pressure. Got it back towards Harrison. Maloney working back. Dutch wrapped up in a tackle.
That's got
came
to be
down to Jarvis. Jarvis a handball back to Fenton. They're going backwards. The ball bowled out. Matthew Fields then on that occasion. Back to Fenton. Delar's had eight possessions and lost 80 metres here. And the ball will be thrown up 35 metres out from the Old Zavarians goal. They lead 39-15, 25 gone, second turn.
One more goal, Delar sell here. It's a three-goal ball game.
Player in a bit of trouble
before
there.
Half-time.
Yeah. That's right, but you it's just can't player. See it happening for them at the moment, can you? Yeah,
ground level, who's the player down?
Can't pick him.
That's McCurry.
That's McCurry. We can't hear you, Peter.
So McCurry is coming off the ground. Umpire about to restart play inside the 45 arc of the Zavs. End of the ground. Handley, a handball. Look for someone there. Rogerson was there. And we'll have another ball up inside the 45-metre arc. John McCurry coming off the ground. He looks a little dazed, but we might see him back on later on. Fields end will see it over the boundary line inside the arc, and we'll have another ball in. 39 playing 15, 26 and a half minutes gone in this second term for Courtney and Patterson Honda. Thrown back in again, Handley up against Nethersole, both got a hand onto it. A clean ball, Cole, but it came out the back to Fenton. Dealer had the footy. Harrison handball back into Close, who handballed dangerously to Lowe, who spikes it into the middle of the ground. Opens the door there for Hale.
Yeah.
Open the door for Vickers.
Here.
Now Manick, no, he's not down there. They look to the top of the square.
That's the kick.
Backing back out they go was Pickett, but he couldn't mark, and it's gone over the boundary line for a ball in deep in the left foot. Pocket.
Really good ball movement there, wasn't it?
Yeah. Much better build up. I know that it was a risky thing by David Lowe to get the spike into the centre, but he had men on. Pickett couldn't hold it. Good defence by Dynan for Old Zavs. Ruck contest coming away. They have it through Williams. He's wrapped up. Can they get it free? De La Celle umpire giving them every opportunity, but finally has to take control of the footy. 27 and a half minutes gone. Old Zavarians have kicked four goals in this quarter. They're on to 6-3-39. Dealer 2-3-15. As Andrew Holmes said, a goal here to Dealer Cell, and they're back within a three goals in a grand final. Nick Roberts, high up and under. Mark wanted. Can it be taken? Dropped by Maloney. Ball comes to ground. Dealer still have it. Fenton hasn't got the distance right up to the top of the goal. Oh no. Pickett nearly a goal. It's been rushed through. One minor score will be the result. Dealer on a 2-4-16, but at least they're back in the ball game. Olds have 6-3-39, 28 gone. Fine Fruits of Eltham scoreboard.
So Wynn kicks the ball back in to Dimitsina, to P&O way side to Colbert. Takes the mark there in front of Duggan outside of the arc. We'll look to go in short in the P&O way side of the ground. Ground bathed in sunshine, starting to get a little bit overcast now though, but the ground in really good nick. Goes long with the kick. Up towards centre wing, the target. Nethersole in front, fisted away in the end. It found Howard, who then ran straight into two De La Celle players in Jarvis and Nethersole. And we'll have a ball up between centre wing and half forward for De La. Thrown in the air outside of the ground. Goes towards the boundary line, though, and it'll go over unless Hale could keep it in. He did. No, he didn't. He ran over the line out of play. We'll have a ball in out of sight.
Late whistle, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, because he was off and gone there, Hale.
Colbert had already given it up, so he knew it was out, but he should be playing at the whistle.
Yeah.
65 metres around from the D-Lar goal. from a commentary perspective, we'd like them to kick one here just to make the ball game a little bit closer. It's 39-16, 29 minutes gone. Probably won't go too long this quarter. 4-1, Old Zaverians have it. They've won most facets of the game, especially the first ball out of these clearances. Have another restart, 65 metres out. Neversol gets the takeaway, got down to Duggan, but he's been turned over. Brad Rogerson wrapped up in a tackle. And we'll have another ball up. 55 metres out from the Dealer goal, kicking to the northern Glen Huntley Road end. And here we go, one more time, I'd suggest, before half-time. Purse against Neversol. Ball comes back to Brad Rogerson. He was dispossessed. Now Hale a chance. He'll kick to the top of the goal square. The ball bounces. Bounces across the face and out of bounds.
So another missed opportunity there for Dealer going towards the pocket. Pickett was really playing for luck there, that it had come back to him. Thrown back in. Hale goes up. Purse just palmed it down. Fished away by Lowe, but he fished it straight to Wynn. And away he goes for Zavs. Clears to the outer side of the ground. Close, playing a very close possession game there on Prowse. No one could win the football. Colbert goes in. Good tackle by Vickers. Umpire says, give it to me, I'll ball it up. Right on the point of the centre square. De La Salle's half forward area. Thrown in the air again, up they go. Purse and Nethersoll both got a hand onto it. Nethersoll's second effort, okay. Got a clearing kick, not a very far one though. Going in, ball got a handball there to Purse. Tackled there by Vickers, going nowhere. We'll have a ball up.
The last 5 to 8 minutes of this quarter is very similar to the first quarter, where a lot of play was played down this end by one team.
Yeah, Neversol again. Fist it clear. Chance there. Kick inside for Dealer. Siren goes to end the second term. And Zavs go in with a fairly healthy lead at halftime. 6-3-39. Playing Dealer 2-4-16. We'll take a break and be back.
You're listening to the VAFA Match of the Day on 96.5 Inner FM and streaming at www.innerfm.org.au.
Okay, third term underway here for Weatherson Foods. De La Salle go in with a 23-point deficit. And let's see if they can get into that deficit by kicking some goals quickly in this third term. Williams has the footy, outer side of the ground. Handball Vickers, handball back. No, he didn't. He stopped and propped. Delivers inside 45, but Wynn backing back takes the mark. In the arc, inside the arc, in defensive 45 for Zavs. Comes across the face of goal to Clark. He takes the mark and looks for the Spruker upfield, and it's Serafini. Ball sits well for him. He'll work the ball towards centre wing. No, he goes over Howard's head, comes out to Fleming out in front. Fished away by Oakley. Fleming's second effort was better than Oakley's, though. He went and had a go. Got a handball in to Serafini, who works the ball to centre half forward to Handley. Watch out, McCary! Oh, he's got you! I don't think you'll get up for a while after that. You could see that coming. Oakley has the footy. Handball back towards Josh Oakley, who works the ball over the head there of McCurry, who's still down to Vickers. Away they go towards Lowe on the outer side of the ground. Purse won't run him down. Lowe might run into him. He nearly kicked the ball into him. He gave it to Howard at centre half back though. Ball came up from Maloney. Handball hit a Gotch. Had to break a tackle. De La Salle with the footy. Oh, watch out. Purse came through. Charged into Duggan. Lost the footy. No free kick. Lowe crunched to the deck. Surely a high tackle, no. And we'll have a ball up at centre half back.
Poor John McCurry, he went off very wobbly just before half time. Obviously they thought he was okay, and now friendly fire by Matt Handley.
It's more than just winded too. I think he's sort of motioning to his ribs.
Not that happy. Now De La Salle, positive thing. They've won a couple of contests out of a stoppage, and they're going to drive the ball deep up into the forward line. Working back Pickett, can't control it. Speaking to a few people off air in the crowd, they were very disappointed with the way the first half has been in front. It's too many stoppages, etc. But for De La Salle, they have to win the first one out. They can't just let stoppage happen.
Well, I think they have to make the game more open.
Exactly.
Because they're a good running side.
Once again, the ball over the line and out of bounds. This time 25 metres around from the De La goal.
Well, he's a dangerous man, McCurry, so I guess the next time the ball comes in his direction, De La Salle have got to knock him and get him right out of the game.
He's Cameron, tough too, though, because he's still out there now.
Cameron Purse probably won the ruck contest. Gets it back to Tim Clark. Now, he was dispossessed. There's a kick off the ground. It's a goal. Someone better help me who it was.
He's about to turn around.
I think it's Duggan, isn't it? I'm certain it's Duggan. Duggan's kicked the goal in his 200th game. Could that be the spark to ignite De La Salle? They go on to 3-4-22, Olzeverian 6-3-39. 3 minutes gone in the third term. That's on the Bendigo Bank of East Ivanhoe scoreboard. And the third term brought to you by Weatherson Foods.
Just going back to that Mercury situation there, Michael. I mean, he's got to be aware that the big fella's leading into the space there. He cut right across the front of him then.
Free kick to Dela.
So Nethersole has the footy. Another goal here will put some shivers up their spines. Up they go. Win in front. Takes the mark in front of Harrison.
It's a poor kick when you get a free run on that, isn't
shocking.
It?
Shocking. Terrible. Wynn marks the ball, goes nearly inside the centre square, but found Rogerson, who works it to the outer side to Colbert. Zabs have the footy, kick up to centre wing to Clark. Met it on the half volley, a long way in front of Lowe. Spins on a strip and he delivers back towards Fleming. Marks on centre wing here for Zabs. Screaming for it, Ryan. Handball Clark, goes back to Wynn. Centre wing, can load up from here if he wants to. Goes all of the way, Hanley backing back. Lynch at the back,
push,
runs into an
push,
open goal
push,
and misses
push,
it.
Push.
Made a push in 25.
And there'll be 25, yep.
Oh, dearie me.
Well, he didn't have to push then.
He didn't.
He could have done it with his body.
Reckon
quite
he missed
easy
it anyway.
But the call of the goal was fantastic.
Thanks, Andrew. Got rather excited myself there. Maloney ends up with it at half back. Delivers a kick to Fieldson, who should mark on his chest, and he does. He called out Nethersole. Back into the middle of the ground for Dela. Oh, one-handed, no good. Maloney picked up there by Roberts. Kick towards half forward. Mark Harrison.
They're up and about early in the third quarter.
They've got to be. Looks for someone to give it to at centre half forward, and he's found his man, and it's Hale. He marks at centre half forward directly in front of goal.
Good signs early. They just they're very committed to the contest, to the loose ball, to manning up on their opponent, all the disciplined things they're meant to be doing, and they're running freely too.
Sorry.
And Hale.
Sorry, I forgot to tap in. I'm drinking.
Well, for that 5 seconds when we went off air, Damien Hale actually kicked from 40 metres out and only kicked at 25 metres. Huge pack of players now around the D-line goal. They've kicked the first goal of the third quarter. And Old Zavarian's about to try and clear. Sam Williams working hard. So's Duggan, who's kicked the goal in this term. And once again, we'll have a ball up. But you just get the feeling that a spark might be ignited here for De La Salle.
They've had all the play.
Their crowd behind their goals, willing another one. Purse, ruck takeaway to Darvell, wrapped up. De La get the ball. David Lowe, the captain, bottom of the pack. No free kick, and once again, we'll have a ball up. As we said, speaking at halftime, are there too many ball ups? Should the umpires pull a couple of free kicks out here? Because it's been very slow motion a lot of the day. Guess what? We're going to have another ball up. No, maybe not. Yes, we are.
I tell you what though, Michael, I'd prefer ball up after ball up than stupid free kicks being pulled out for the sake of breaking it up.
Yeah, well, I suppose so, but we could have ball ups for the next 10 minutes here.
That's
at
okay.
The moment.
That's okay.
In front of the scoreboard, it's De La Salle 3-4-22, Old Zavarian 6-3-39. And whilst I've been talking, we had another ball up, and now we're going to have another one. Yep. We have another ball up. Simon Petch, take us through the next four ball ups.
Okay, I'll do my best. 39 playing 22, 6.5 gone third term. We're down at De La Salle's end. They're kicking to the scoreboard end. Harrison won it down. Jared Maloney couldn't win it. Fleming did. He gave it to Bowen, who puts it high in the sky, close underneath. It goes back. Courage.
Free kick
couldn't
to Hanley.
Couldn't take the mark.
Free kick to Hanley.
And Hanley's been given a free kick for a push anyway. So between centre wing and half back for Zavs. Hanley goes long as he possibly can. Serafini might be on here. Yes, he is. He's taken the mark inside the arc and will go back and surely have a shot on goal here. Good judgment there, going back with the flight. Nice kick by Hanley too to cover the ground. So Serafini, who's one of the spruikers at the Spring Carnival this year, or attempting to be, winning that large prize that's on offer.
$10,000.
Yeah, having a shot on goal here for Old Zavs from the 45 metre arc. Beautiful kick off the boot all the way through the goal. That's seven goals for Zavs. That's taking them on to 7-3-45. Dela on 3-4-22. That on the Bendigo Bank East Ivanhoe scoreboard for Weatherson Foods. We've played 7.5 third term.
Andrew and Kent, virtually against the play, that goal.
Yes, but by gee, the player that handled it all in Serafini, what an accomplished footballer he is. I mean, we think of him more of a dashing, defending, attacking player, but to get him up and kick the goal, it looked like he's been homemade to kick a goal.
Hurst won it out to Agius. Now Zavs break three, straight out of the middle, up towards Lynch.
Great mark.
Yeah. And the big man stands up in between Jarvis and Fenton and takes the mark.
And he's a much better player going for the mark without putting hands on players, isn't he, Lynch? I mean, he does that too often for mine. When he's
well, there was no hands then. There was only hands for the football. And for once, we had a clear takeaway out of the middle. Wasn't it great?
One kick, yep.
Purse went to AGS, down to Lynch. He had McCurry underneath him roving. So he looks okay, John McCurry. And Damien Lynch to kick Severian's second within 60 seconds comes in.
Oh, yes.
Crowd behind the goal say, all clear, another one to Old Zavs. On to 8-3-51, they're withstanding their challenge at the moment. De La Salle, 3-4-22. That's on the Bendigo Bank of East Ivanhoe scoreboard in the third term for Weatherson Foods.
It's an interesting
Tony
Kennis
is joining to give us a handout with some comments during this
talk,
quarter.
John.
I was going to say it was a nice centre clearance and a good mark from Lynch in a strong contest.
And that's really the first straight centre clearance we've had all day, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah.
Back in the middle. Purse up against Nethersole, and Nethersole won the tap. Agius through the middle again, high up and under kick. Fleming held on to, surely a free kick, no. Umpire said play on, kick off the ground by Hale. Dilar working out towards Davidson on the arc. Handball dangerously inside to Vickers, though. Diving over the top, Hanley couldn't win the footy. Handball came out the Nethersole. Handball to Davidson. Kicked to centre wing, out of sight of the ground, out of play deliberately, surely. Umpire said no, we'll have a ball in. Well, was he going anywhere else with that kick?
Well,
no,
we're just brought about because of the pressure on the ball carrier every time. They just have to try and retreat at some stage.
Thrown in again, Purse at the back and got the tap down. And once again, another ball up.
While we've got you, John, you're coaching De La Salle for the moment. What would you do?
I'd probably continue on with the broadcast. Sorry.
Kick away, up towards, well, pray is what I'd be doing because I can't see anything else working for them at the moment. Just at the moment.
Well, you could get a bit callous and say get ready for next year.
Well, come on.
It's not over yet.
I mean,
it's not over yet.
They've just got to take risks.
I didn't say I'd say it. I'm suggesting someone else could say it.
They've just got to continue to take risks and do what they do.
That's right. Just take a risk or two. It's not going to hurt.
Well, we made that point before the game. Well, what they've done for the whole part of the year has worked because they're a good side. They've just got to stick to their structure. They get beaten by a better side on the day, so be it.
You just had a look at that last stoppage then. It was very narrow. A lot of players around the ball. And
Colbert ends up with a free kick
steps.
And have found
That's
McCurry right. who marked the football, but Davidson, who was a long, long way away from that, has come in and decided he's going to ball that one up. Gee, Wiz, how can you... Anyway, thrown in the air, up they go, Handley, fisted down. Williams, good tackle there. Lost the footy to Ben Oakley, now a chance. Davidson, good tackling by Zavs again. Underneath was Howard, found Colbert, somehow spun out of trouble, high tackle. He gets the free kick directly in front of goal.
Again, a very tight pack situation. Nowhere for Dilar to be giving their hands and get running and get clear of the pack. Every handball that was received was tackled.
Colbert's kicked one so far today, looking at goal number two. They've kicked eight for the day.
There's also a very good reason why we get so many ball ups and congested plays because, again, there's only four players forward of the centre circle for De La Salle. They're just pushing all the players back in the defensive zone.
Should have no problem here. Ryan Colbert kicking his second of the afternoon from 40 metres. Puts it on its way. Misses all. Look at Sagoda. Gee, had to make some ground up there. Moved across rather quickly to his right and signalled a minor score. 52 playing 22. Zavs have the lead. 12 minutes gone.
Dila dangerously towards Davidson, holds his feet, gets it outside the defensive arc, in towards little Gotch, can't take the mark. Vickers at the bottom of the pack couldn't do so. Ryan off Rogerson, they're going backwards, Zavs, before they go forward. To Dimatina, all a chain of handballs to Matt Ball. Short kick into the skipper in Fleming, playing his last game. Fleming up towards the half forward line. Handley in front, can't take the ball. Turnover, De La Salle ends up with Ben Corran. Big man, poor handball, goes backwards. They've got to deliver better to Davidson. They've turned it over. Ball ended up there with Oakley. He got a handball away to Fenton, and Fenton will get the handball. They really still haven't got it clear out of defensive 45. They're not going to do so. It comes back to Fleming for Old Zavarians. Kicks up towards Lynch. Ball at the bottom of the pack. Darvell gets it. And now I bet you we get a ball up. One handle too many?
Just under pressure. I mean,
that's what it was.
But Zabs in the last 5 minutes have just been overcome with this relentless, ruthless attack on the ball and the player with the ball. And they're just getting no space or no ability to deliver it.
Well, you've got to pay full marks to Zabs with all of that there. That was just, they put them under the hammer every opportunity then. Terrific play.
See the way they're set up. Everyone man on man around the ball and then numbers back. So
thrown in, 46 out from Zab's goal. So Papo to the front of the pack. Vickers there in the way though. Handball along the ground. Pick up there by Ball. Handball Dimitrina. Had to fend them off. Went out of play. Have the ball in between half forward and centre wing for Old Zabs. Attacking to the Glen Huntley Road end in this second turn. They lead by 30 points. 13 and a half minutes gone. Up they go. Corrin from the fist got it down to ground level. Colbert fell over. Going in there is Dynan. A handball back ball. Didn't read it properly. And a scramble emerges again for another ball up.
John, a couple of people said to me at halftime, this is effectively like an under-9s or an under-10s match where everyone just jumps on the ball.
Yeah, well, you can just see the big pack of players there again around the ball.
And Ball it was who actually got that one out to Howard, who puts it around the body up towards half forward. Bouncing ball Oakley. He left it there for Maloney, who then sees it out of play. We'll have another ball in, out of sight.
Barnaby Willis at ground level conditions. There's no wind at all now.
Totally benign.
Thanks, Barn.
Jeez. Very tranquil.
It's good today.
He's sharp as.
Ben Corrin, ruck contest. Sapapo in front. Supporting Purse very well. They're winning the ruck contest. It came back to Colbert. Colbert gets the handball backwards before they go forwards through Dimitina. Right up to the half forward line. Good working back and taking the mark on that occasion was Hale for De La Salle. Now they've got to get the run going. Hale goes very wide to his other under-19 star from last year in Williams. Sam Williams going backwards. Left foot, chips up the line, looking for Jarvis. But once again, they break down at half-back and the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. Good result for Old Zavarians.
Never looked like taking that mark, and I don't know why a couple of Old Zavs didn't come over and really let him know that he didn't
take it matters.
Mark.
I think it just did on the way through. But he looks a bit lame, Luke Jarvis.
He does. Ruck contest comes to ground. Tim Clark right around the corner, up towards the top of the square. Hanley has it punched away. Sapapo up towards the full forward line, over the line and out of bounds. And we'll have a throw in 15 metres around from the Zavs goal. They lead 8-4 to 3-4, 15 gone. Third term for the Bendigo Bank of East Ivanhoe.
Jared Maloney then just put Mac Ball on the deck off the ball, but they need to show a little bit more of that intensity when the ball's in dispute.
Hanley got it down front of the pack, going back in underneath it. Well done, Nick Smith. He won the football, then lost it. Jared Maloney, a handball. Close to the boundary line for DeLow, out of play.
Been a lot of stoppages in the last 5-7 minutes, haven't there?
No, in the last 87 minutes.
Shutting the game down.
Minutes.
I mean, how long has it been since we've had a DeLow forward 50 entry?
Yeah.
Thrown in again, Corrin just used the body on Sapapo, won it down, Nick Roberts, Josh Oakley handball out, but then goes in after it again, and once again, another ball up, 48 out.
But John, as a coach, like, does that worry you, or are you happy to have that occur, and how do you break it up?
How do you break up? Oh, well, you've got to win the ball, feed it back, and get around and get it moving. It's but you pull blokes back from the stoppage, I think.
Yeah.
Shields ends up with the football, goes inside the arc, fished away Rogerson. Who's at the front? Maloney there. Chance Davidson, kick. Oh, gee, missed the target there. It hit Larkins. And once again, the umpire says, give it to me, we'll have another ball up.
I think you have to be fair to Zabs in this instance, because they're playing against a side, if you give them an inch, they're going to take a lot more than that. That's the way they play
the
game.
The game's certainly been played under Zabs' terms. They win the ball out of the stoppage. They go down to full forward, and a man who's had a fairly tough day, John McCurry, whether it being hit by himself, his opponents, but he's taken the mark, and he's usually a pretty good goal kicker. He's 35 metres out directly in front.
But like John said, though, like if a De La Salle or two or three De La Salle players come back off the pack and create themselves in dangerous positions, they're going to force a Zaz player to come with them, because they're going to have to man up on them. And then you extract six players out of what is 18.
McCurry comes in, and as soon as I say he's a good kick, he pushes it right. One minor score. 2-1 to John McCurry. 8-5 to Old Zavarians. That's 53. De La, 3-4, 22. 17 gone, and this third term brought to you by Weatherson's Foods.
Ben Oakley kicks the ball back in. AGS underneath it. Up he goes. Fished away by Corrin. Out of play. We'll have a ball in. 48 out.
Dick Lassell just can't get it out of there, can they?
No.
Draw as they might, they just cannot find a way out of that sort of 55-metre mark.
Thrown back in again. Corrin and Sapapo both got a hand onto it. Jared Maloney handball. Missed Williams. Hits Sapapo. Kick towards top of the square. Oh, gee, coming through Fenton. Maloney nearly got in his way, but Fenton takes the mark. Handball back towards Close. Close to the goal area. He keeps it away. He goes towards the Pean Highway side to Hale. He marks for Dilar. Still a long way from home. Deep in defence. Inside the 45-metre arc. He looks up the ground. He goes as long as he can with the kick. But a shocking kick in the end. And it's hit Serafini virtually in front of the eyes. He goes towards centre half forward with a kick to Darvell. He marks. Point of the centre square. Coming out is a Lynch or Handley. Handley making a half-hearted lead. Darvell goes long as he can. Backing back. Oh, Aegeus is in the right spot. Just couldn't claim the footy. Ball hits the deck and away go Dilar with a kick to centre wing. Might open the door up for them here. Mark taken here by Nick Roberts. There's no one to kick to at centre half forward though. Has to stop and wait with the handball. Handball there to Pickett, who goes towards top of the square. Up they go, up in front. Nethersole cart mark crunched. He's down. He's out of play virtually. And a foul win, who goes to Dine and who kicks it clear to Prowse.
Esmond Prowse about to take control of the footy, although wrapped up there by Dilar Sell. They look much better if the ball just keeps on moving. And now it's not going to. We're going to have a restart. Half forward flank for Dilar Sell. Better build up there, John.
Yeah, much better build up. I might have been tempted to keep running and have a slot at the goal there, sorry. I think, because the Xavier people were moving back through the midfield to force it 3-on-1.
Left Nethersall 3-on-1, didn't it? So, whilst John was talking, we had another bounce, and now we'll get another bounce.
And McCurry's come off the ground, too. Might pay Barnaby if he can go down there and just see exactly what the problem is with John, because he may have stayed on the ground a bit too long.
And we had another bounce, and now we're having another bounce.
I think, too, like, you know, on John's point, too, and I agree, is that, you know, if that player there has a shot at goal, it tells Xavier that we're actually going to have a crack at the score, you know, the scoring opportunity here, rather than always palming it off, because they're now thinking that they're not going to have a shot.
Yep. Now we're still...
another ball up, another stoppage.
Right, so from that little frenetic burst of play when Dilar Sell brought the ball up one side and Zav's got it and turned it round to the half-forward flank at the Dilar end, in the next 80 seconds we've had four bounces and the ball has gone absolutely nowhere.
Well, Barnaby's gone somewhere. He's gone down to just check on John McCurry, see how he is. Corrin Fissaclea found Rogerson, though, on the back end of it. Handball to Clark around the body, nearly out of play. Will it stay in? Howard will make sure it does. Upended in the end there by Tom Maloney. Got a kick towards centre wing. Opens the door up here for Nick Smith. Puts it onto his boot. Kicks towards half forward to Hanley. He marks on hands and knees 50 metres out from goal for Zavs. Attacking to the Glen Huntley right into the ground. Lynch wants it long. He does just that. Puts it high in the air. Jarvis in front. Lynch at the back goal. He was always going to win that contest. And at the 21-minute mark of the third term, Zavs kick their eighth, ninth. They go into 9-5-59. Dilar 3-4-22. That on the Bendigo Bank East Ivanhoe scoreboard. We've gone 21 minutes for Weatherson Foods third term.
Again, just from that succession of stoppages there, big mob of players around the ball. Finally, Zavs got it clear. They spread, they run, all back, easy goal, easy possessions round the wing, and good kick from Handley to Lynch.
Yep. Well, they're playing to their strengths all the time, aren't they? I mean, they're playing to a plan to stop the running players and using their strength to break up the pack.
Duggan got it to Nethersole, who went to David Lowe, but as John Kennis and Ken Petrucco said, they're always under pressure. Lowe gets a free kick for above the shoulder, up to the half-forward line. Flying high, Harrison dropped the ball, went to Serafini. Now they're on Old Zavarians. They've got a big break. It's the youngster in Esmond Prowse. He runs onto the ball, a man with a great name. Chips up to the full forward line. Dropping what he could have taken was Fleming, dispossessed. And the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. 35 metres out from the Old Zavarians' goal.
See, now, if you just look over the field now, you can see the Dilar half forward line coming around to crowd this situation, and the Dilar half back's just sitting here waiting for the ball to come back. So, not only are they pressured there,
Double pressure free kick against Old Zavarians on this occasion, and it'll go back there and it'll go to Nethersole. Ground level, Barnaby Willis.
Yeah, just with John McCurry, a little bit distressed high in the chest, just below the throat area. Just Shields. A bit of an area of concern.
Shields has just come off injured too.
Okay, he's been playing injured all day.
Yeah,
Hale to Fenton. who works it to Vickers, a handball, Gotch, Vickers gets it back. Through the middle go Dilar, kick to half forward, Mannix in front. Oh, he hasn't taken it. Chopped out of his hands in the end towards the boundary line. He goes in again. So does Tom Maloney over the boundary line, and we'll have Jared Maloney will have the ball in. So at half forward for Dilar. 59 playing 22, Zavs have the lead. Ball being thrown back in, Nethersole up against Purse. Purse winnings it down to Colbert. Nearly dacked in the end, Serafini handball to Clark. Torpedoes a kick up towards half forward. Sits okay for Tom Maloney. He takes the mark on his chest. They break for him in the middle. He looks backwards first before he looks forward. And he still hasn't moved.
And this is exactly what Zavs love, isn't it? Slow the game. Nowhere to kick the ball. Goes everything to, tight.
Now he finds Gotch loose on centre wing. Handball to Fields in, who out runs and kicks it out of bounds on the full result and free kicks Zavs way.
There aren't enough players to deal with still on the move forward of the ball carrier. Basically, I mean, you can play man on man and, you know, Zavs can be, you know, disciplined in that area, but you've got to be on the move. You've got to keep rotating through and make one or two or three different leads.
Tim Clark kicks up there looking for Prowse, who takes the mark. Outreaching Jake Gotch to Esmond Prowse. Goes into the centre looking for Hanley at half forward. He left without the football but recovered well enough and then got a handball away. Oh. Tom Maloney missed the football. It came down to Nick Roberts. He went to Fenton. Fenton a quick handball across to close for De La Salle. This is where they've been falling down.
Gone.
He got the handball to Hale.
Wonderful
Hale
tackle.
Had an opportunity and umpire Davidson felt sorry for him and gave him a free kick. So Sam Hale, fortuitous on that occasion. At half-back flank, they're still getting themselves in trouble. Goes into the centre, finds Duggan. A quick handball over the top to Gotch. He's under pressure. Goes back to Nethersole. He's under pressure. He goes back to Nick Roberts. Chips up poorly to the half-forward line. Coming through was Oakley. Oakley on the left. Gets a handball away, back to Nethersole. Umpire calls advantage. The loping ruckman Nethersole from 45. Up high to the top of the goal square. And a great mark back in defence there. Four
Tim
old Zavarians.
Fleming.
By Fleming.
Yep.
Yeah.
He's done it all of the afternoon. That was a shocking kick to Hale in front of goal, surely.
No.
No. Minor score.
Zavs are reading that that hook kick back from DLSL from this pocket into the hot spot in front of goal really well, because just getting numbers there, because I know they're going to do it every time.
All right, Bowen to kick it back in. Goes in very, very short to Ball, who marks down in defensive back pocket right in front of the scoreboard. 59 playing 23, Zavs have led all of the afternoon. And at the 25 and a half minute mark of the third turn, they continue to do that. Goes out to the outer side of the ground to Dynan, who marks in the opposite back pocket. Nepean Highway side of the ground. Heading Glen Huntley Road in Zavs in this third term. Up they go. Howard couldn't mark. Ball fell to the deck. Got a good pick up there in the end there by Prowse. A handball to Darvell, who read it beautifully. Now spins out of trouble easily. Kick on his boot towards Hanley. Curran the fisted punch at the back. Ball fell to ground. Chance now for Tom Maloney. A handball to Fenton. Handball back to Tom Maloney. Dilar on the move. Held up there by Ryan. Handball backwards to Fenton. Handball inside here towards Hale. Handball backwards again. They go to Williams. Oh, nearly tripped up by Darvell. Handball chopped off by Colbert. Handball towards centre wing. Away they go again through Ryan. Handball found Howard. High up and under. Kick underneath at Fenton. Had to wait an eternity. He marked it on his chest at half back out of sight.
They just keep turning the ball over. They can't break them. Fenton to Nethersole. Nethersole into the centre to Josh Oakley. Now he can run. He goes through the centre of Sports Cover Arena. Takes a bounce. Pinpoint pass up to Fields End. Oh, not Fields End. Pickett, who takes the mark. Pickett chips up looking for Fields End. And
he
now Matt Fields End. I knew he'd end up with it. It's in the script. And he's taken the mark. 6 goals the difference. 26 and a half minutes gone. And the Woodrow medalist needs to slot this one to give Dilar any hope, John Kennis, coming into the last turn.
Just played a little bit more expansively, got away from where the numbers were, composed with the first kick in, didn't go the initial leads, kicked it to Pickett, and good result.
Matthew Fields then unloads across the face. Dilar need a rover. The rover's Roberts up to the top of the goal square, rush through one behind. Great defence, old Zavarians. 9-5 they are, Dilar a 3-6. 27 gone, third term for Weatherson Foods.
Shouldn't be much longer left in this third term. And you would think an unassailable lead for Zavs going into the final quarter. Bowen taking a while, kicks the ball back in, inside the centre square, Purse had it fisted away by Ben Oakley, ball fell to Duggan, handball inside, Gotch ran onto it, wants to give another handball, he does to Duggan, dangerously a kick towards top of the square, Harrison, oh Maddox, in from the side, ball fell to Harrison, into an open goal and he kicked it, wow. Two danger players in their half forward area, Maddox and Harrison, they combine there and Harrison kicks the goal, that's their fourth. They go on a 4-6-30. Zabs on 9-5, 59-28, gone third term. That on the Bendigo Banco Simon O scoreboard.
John, quick ball movement?
Yep, well look, good pressure from Zabs in the middle. When Duggan got the ball, the first option he was going to give was actually covered over, got away with the second one, and they had the numbers there for a change.
29 and a half, well, that's it. So they've got one right on three-quarter time, Siren. 28 minutes and 26 seconds that quarter went. And Old Zavarian still won the term. They kicked 3 goals, 2 to 2 goals, 2. Dillard just started to look a little bit better towards the end of that term, but they've got a Herculean task to perform here in the last term if they're to get out of this.
Very tight, boys.
Were you asked to address the players?
I lost you.
Selective hearing. Okay, final term about to get underway here for McDonald's Family Restaurants. There's only 29 points in it. Anything could happen in this final term. Let's hope for De La Salle supporters they kick the first couple of goals and really put the shivers up the spines of Old Zavarians early in this final term. So another ball up in the middle of the ground. Up they go. Purse won it down. Reading it well there was Ball, who's brought to ground. And once again, we'll have another ball up.
Just Johnny Cannons, how great was it to have a coach up here for a grand final, talking us through what is actually happening out there in the huddles.
Unfortunately for John, he's done it the last 3 years for us, so I think he wants to be involved.
Purse won it down, D'Lo win the footy, then they lost it, a handball came back. Kick away there by Ball towards half forward. Aegeus onto it, Aegeus into goal, misses everything out of bounds on the full. Resultant free kick to go to Corrin, deep in the back pocket, scoreboard end of the ground.
Ben Corrin in front of the Old Zavarians faithful there at the scoreboard end. He elects to run it very wide. Now David Lowe, one-on-one situation against Matt Ball. Lowe has the pace, has the balance. Balances up beautifully, gets the handball in towards Hale. He was wrapped up, but he managed to break the tackle. This is crucial. Gets the handball to Nick Roberts, goes to half forward. Wobbly kick. They've just got to get the ball to ground level. They do that. They all fall on top of it. Oakley and Harrison for De La Salle will get a resultant ball up, but this time 30 metres out from the De La Salle goal.
Harrison was just caught behind his opponent then and just a little bit flat-footed, but he knew the ball was coming in because it was telegraphed that way. He had to be in front of his opponent.
As long as they're not outmarked, but they were in the takeaway. Darvell got it away, out very wide. 2-on-1. Ooh, crucial free kick on that occasion goes to Aegeus against Oakley, and Josh Aegeus takes it, defensive 45. Chips up to Brad Rogerson, who takes the mark. Been pretty much a quiet achiever, Rogerson. Good at the stoppages. Goes along the line up there and finding Chris Smith. The youngster been very good. Chris Smith just works up the line. Nethersole in front. Can't take control. Ball beats Hanley and Corrin over the line. No change to three-quarter time. Old Zabs 9-5-59. De La Salle 4-6-30. Final term brought to you by McDonald's.
29 points the margin. Zabs have the lead. Ball thrown back in. Purse pounded it down. Darvell tackled by Pickett. Handball tied. Jared Maloney back to Pickett, who's held up there by Purse. Over the shoulder. Free kick going De La Salle's way here on centre wing. They want to be a wake up at half forward. Harrison makes the lead. He goes to Fields in. Oh, not a real good kick. Put him under pressure. Goes back into the centre square with a kick. Finds Lowe. Puts it under the arm. Goes for a run. Takes them on. Centre half forward. The target over Harrison's head.
Over the back.
Out the back. Oakley. Oakley in the goal. No. Ball to ground. By Dimitrina in the back. Free kick going Oakley's way.
Pretty ordinary that.
No, that was there.
Like to see the video.
That was there because we want this grand final to be a close one.
Yep, here he is, Ben Oakley into an open goal. Surely won't miss that from there, he won't! They've kicked their fifth. 23 points the margin. Zavs have the lead, but we've gone 3 minutes into this final term. 59 playing 36. That on the McDonald's Family Restaurants. No dinner at 8 scoreboard and for McDonald's Family Restaurants. 3 gone.
Well, fair dinkum, if they were playing those as pushes all day today, there would have been up to about 35 of them.
Yes, I just don't know. He was running forward. I think he might have just tapped him in the back, but he fell over anyway. Fortuitous goal to De La Salle. What the game needed anyway. Zav's win it out of the centre through Darvell. Up to the centre half forward position. Zav's usually answering this situation. John McCurry! No! Kicks it wide. One minus score. And it's back out to a four goal ball game. 9-6-60 to 5-6-36. 3 minutes gone on the dinner at 8 scoreboard. Final term of the grand final for 2009.
Tough as T. McCurry. He showed that last year as well. AGS and Pickett. Pickett went the football. AGS had a look. Good tackle, AGS. Handball here to Jarvis. Heard the call in the middle. Away go Dela. Handball low. They call for it. Oakley. No. Harrison in front. Fished away by Bowen. Oakley gets there now. Puts it on its way. High kick. Out of play. Sagoda said it's gone too far. Over the line, out of play, resulting free kick to go to win for
Zavs. I know it was
going to
be tough, but he really had to try and centre it, didn't he?
Yeah.
To get the ball back in play.
Oh, kick a goal from there. Like, give the supporters something.
Yeah, but he couldn't, though.
Have a go.
Nine impossible. He was off balance, virtually. Yeah. Very, very tough. Nick Wynn, gun recruit.
Bugger the percentages now. Just have a go.
Back pocket, drives the ball, outside defensive 45. Good kick on that occasion, and Nethersole and Purse both see it over the line. Both been tireless workers in the ruck today. He'll sleep well tonight, Sam Nethersole. He's done virtually most of it on his own. And in the ruck contest, once again, it's a man-on-man situation. Suits Zavs very well, and they nearly clear, although it's stolen by Zav, by Dela, right up to the full forward line. Two-on-two contest. Harrison keeps his feet, working back Dimatina, gets the handball to Bowen on the left foot, and he kicks it wide. You can hear in the effects, Mike, the Dela Cell crowd building behind the goals. Free kick goes to Nethersole. Now he's got to be good. Wasn't good enough. Beats Mrs. Fields in. Punch over the line by Rogerson. Out of bounds. And we're going to throw in 30 metres out.
Great defence again from Zavs under a lot of pressure from the crowd.
Yeah, the DLR forwards just have to play in front. They're 1 or 2 metres behind their opponents, and they've just got to get in front and take possession of the ball.
Ball to be thrown back in. Glenn Huntley right into the ground. Gee, he's taking an eternity, this boundary umpire. Get on with it. Throws it in now.
You're under
Ben Oakley at the back. Purse in front. They both didn't get a hand onto that at all. And we'll have another ball up inside the 45 arc.
Andrew and Ken, you see, with that boundary stoppage taking that long, there's so many players around the ball. This suits Zavs.
Yeah, absolutely right.
Thrown in the air again. Purse down. Found a teammate. Darvell slung. Handball, a loose one. Chance Williams. High kick. Top of the square. Harrison from behind. He went the spoil. He couldn't get in front of Wynn.
Beyond
and he
again.
Takes the mark.
Terrific mark.
Beyond
terrific.
Again.
And a great player.
Get in front.
He should have gone the spoiling punch. He went the mark. Wynn has the footy. Kick towards McCurry. Over Oakley! Oh. No, he couldn't hold on to it. Goes to ground. Free kick. Coming which way?
McCurry's
way.
Now that is weak. That push in the back before was weak. That is just not there.
So he can hardly stand up here, John McCurry, but he's going to play the game out because he's tough ass. Centre wing goes the ball. Luke Howard in front of the contest over the back there with Fenton. Oh, gee, a high
great
tackle.
Kick.
Surely going Dela's way there against Colbert. He'll go Close's way at halfback.
Go to Close against Colbert. Been very good, Daniel Close, all day here for Dela's self.
Yep.
He's got the ball
players
on halfback. It's 60 to 36, so Dela's still, scoreboard-wise, still in the game. They wouldn't want to just slow it down like this. They've got to work for it quickly. Up to Davidson. Now to Josh Oakley coming into the game. Michael Duggan on. He's got Maloney short of the Tom variety. He's going to go very, very short again. And he'll go back to Daniel Close. Well, they're building up the stats, Dela, but they're not getting forward quick enough. I appreciate they've got to make the right move, but they've got to make it fairly quickly. Handball over the top, Tom Maloney. I don't know if this is the right move at the moment because a turnover to McCurry. Now Lynch is one-on-one with Jarvis in front of him. Dangerous for Dela Cell. Can Fenton recover? No, he can't. Poor build-up on that occasion.
Dela Cell. He's a liability, McCurry, too. He should be off the ground.
Dela Cell aren't really fending him just at the moment. All their movement along here is half-hearted. They stop halfway through a lead. Hands aren't up in the air.
Handley, ruck contest. Now Howard. Oh, he handballed it straight up to Williams. Handball here towards Jared Maloney. Nowhere to kick. He goes towards Duggan, centre wing in front. Can't mark. At the back there was Ryan. Oh, well played here. Hale, he put his head over the footy. Can't win it. We'll have a ball up centre wing and McCurry does go off. So he should. Thrown in the air again. Nethersole won that one down low, trapped it well, had to beat a tackle. Handball Hale, kick high up and under. Fieldson in front, the back. Great mark, great. Win again. Terrific mark over the back of Fieldson at half back. He's got Dynan on short, he uses him up at a half back, right in front of us here. Goes back into the middle of the ground. Good kick, Sue. Hit the target there in Rogerson, who can go all the way out wide in the P&O way side to Fleming, and away goes Zaps.
So Bowen, I think it is, Bowen, bombs the ball up long, up looking for Esmond Prowse. Esmond Prowse in front of Fenton. Both had fair games. Prowse on this occasion has the ball. Goes back there to Ryan. Ryan across, up to the half forward line. Oh, right over the top. Left Pickett. Fell over the lot of them, came down to Jake Gotch. Gotch went in towards the centre. Now on the overlap, quick handball away there. Came from close. Now they're going to turn it over again, De La Salle, I think. One of them was Larkins for old Zevs. Came back though to Pickett, who got the handball to Gotch. De La Salle still pushing forward and dangerously up to Matthew Fields' end. You'd suggest they need a goal with this forward thrust. Matthew Fields' end! Enters brilliantly! And they're still alive. It's 9-6-60 to 6-6-42. Probably one of the better build-ups of the day for De La Salle. We haven't gone 10 minutes. The scoreboard brought to you by Dinner at 8.
Well, certainly the best goal of the day. Magnificent kick from Fieldson there. And a good lifter for the side. Still game on.
There's a bit of an X factor too, because like we caught him coming into the play in the third quarter. And he's just about to come into it again now by the looks of that.
So another goal here would be great. They get a free kick, centre ruck contest. Nethersole to take it. Now, he's got to have a moving forward. Duggan, Mannix, Harrison, they're all there. High kick there by Gotch. Underneath the Duggan. Mannix from the back. Got it down to Josh Oakley. Heard the call, gave it to Williams. Got a good handball. Charging in those abs. Rail wing goes towards the boundary line. Deliberate? No. Ball it in.
Good decision.
Absolutely. He was probably too far out to make that deliberate. Thrown in again. Oakley goes up. Purse won that one. Duggan. Oh, no. Jared Maloney kicked a full forward. Mark taken here by Winnegan.
So Nick Wynn having plenty of the football, not only in the last quarter, but all day and all year. Great footballer. 19 years of age. Kicks long along the boundary line. Oakley coming into the game of the bend variety. Came down to Maloney for De La Salle. Wrapped up in a tackle by Larkins. It was a great effort, Ken and Andrew, just before when Larkins wrapped up Sam Williams, who was on the overlap and charging forward. So good defence from the Old Zavarians. Purse got it down towards Clark. Agius in for Old Zavs. Clark kick along the ground. Ends up there with Prowse. Kicks the ball across his body. Up to the half forward line for Old Zavarians. Maloney tackled high. He'll get the free kick.
No.
Get a handball to Fenton, but unfortunately the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. 11 and a half minutes gone in the 2009 VAFA A-section grand final. Old Zavarians lead 60 to 42.
Thrown back in centre wing. Purse goes up on his lonesome. Got it down to Darvell. Wrapped up by Jared Maloney. Umpire said, give it back to me. I'll do what I just did before.
While they've worked into the game, gentlemen, you think they've got to make everything stick. They can't afford to muck things up, D-Lo, can they?
No, thrown up again. Purse got it down. Jared Maloney again. Fell over. Handball deliberate that one. No.
That free kick and handball back there about a minute, you know, 1 minute ago was just a waste of an opportunity.
So they've made 10 metres towards their goal. De La Salle and Glenn Huntley right into the ground. Up they go. Purse double-handed down. Clark couldn't control that. Came too quickly for him.
What we have noticed, though, Simon, is the congestion around the ball has really sort of dried up. There's a lot more players now playing in their positions and actually spreading, because I know that any kick out, they're going to have numbers at the fall of the ball.
Absolutely. It's more open now than it had been in those first three. Clark couldn't control it. Oh, gee, Hale just bounced off him. Kick along the ground might work. It
great
does.
Pick up.
Good pick up by Pickett. Goes towards half forward over Fieldsland's head, though. What a shocking kick.
Well,
a terrible kick.
It wasn't a great kick, wasn't it?
Well, they're leading out from the square. Take it in.
I think wrong option.
Yeah. Thrown back in again. Oakley down to the front of the pack. Fished away by Pickett. Opens the door for Mannix.
Hold it in.
Goes to ground. Umpire said, give it to me, I'll ball it up.
Now's a real opportunity for them to try and create something out of nothing, get within two goals, and make this grand final one that's going to go right down to the wire.
Oakley down to Pickett in a goal, but he misses. So missed opportunity there. 13 gone in the final term for McDonald's Family Restaurants. And Zavs have the lead. 9-6-60 to 6-7-43 for Dinner at 8.
I think at one stage it was 9-3. So I think Dealer's kicked the last three goals here. And Bowen being put under pressure by the De La Salle faithful who have turned out this afternoon. So Andy Bowen, the state centre-half fullback, goes straight up the ground and finds Chris Larkins. Larkins takes the mark and goes right out towards commentary side centre wing. In front, good mark, Michael Davidson. Standing tall on that occasion against Prowse. He's got Fields End on. Davo didn't listen to Fields End and going up towards Mannix in front. Pushed out in the contest. In the back against Nick Wynn. And...
you can't pay that.
Well...
rubbish.
He let it go.
Yes, he pulled his hands back.
How smart is he? He's a smart player, Mannix.
He is. I'm sure if it was a handball given to him, Simon, he would have showed a little bit more effort to actually get the ball.
What we can say, though, we've had 14 and a half minutes of this last quarter. I reckon about 12 minutes has been played this half at the end of the ground.
Crucial kick.
Zabs have had one shot at goal.
35 metres out. Ben Mannix stops and starts. Don't think we'll need the goal umpire to tell us what it is because you've got 1,000 people behind him. At the Glen Huntley Road end, Ben Mannix, the veteran for De La Salle, comes in. Up in the air. It's definitely there and it's game on. 7-7-49 De La Salle. Odds of variance 9-6-60. Ken and Andrew, I think the free kick was there. I don't know about the 25.
Correct.
Yeah, couldn't agree more.
How can the umpire fall for that? Honestly.
This is the grand final we've been looking for.
Yeah.
11 points of margin with about 10, 12 minutes to go.
Yeah, they just needed a couple of goals, didn't they? De La against Zabs getting nothing, and away we go again, middle of the ground. So Papo won it down, charging through Larkins, handball Colbert. Oh, he had to get rid of it quickly. Serafini, a high up and under kick towards half, forward underneath it. Ryan fisted it away. De La in the van, handball Maloney, goes towards low the boundary line. Handball back to Nethersole. He turns one way, had a look to Hale. Gotch, away he goes. Handball Williams. Handball to Fenton. He can go to centre half board. Oh, dangerous. Handball. Oh, Davidson got through somehow. Kick to full forward, Mannix.
Brilliant.
Winner's taken the mark. Last line of defence.
He's been brilliant.
Works a handball to Bowen, who works it out in the P&OA side. Out to Dynan. Races on with Hale. Guy, ball goes over the boundary line. We'll have a ball in.
Ken, something that De La are now doing, they're running to position to receive handballs really, really cleverly. Like they're getting around to the front of the ball carriers to actually be able to receive it.
Yes, they've lifted their game, no question about that.
Centre wing out of side, David Sapapo gets the handball away only as far as Sam Williams. He was dispossessed. And once again, we'll get a ball up. Well, it took us about 95 to 100 minutes to get some really good free-flowing footy going from either end. It's happening now. Zavs lead by 11. Larkins gets the takeaway. And once again, we'll have a ball up again. Hopefully, I didn't stop the free-flowing play.
Well, to each coach's credit, they actually push their players back into the conventional positions, and it's actually just a normal game of footy now.
Well, normal it is, but it's a grand final. There's 10 minutes to go. Pickett gets it to Hale. They're going to run. They're going to carry. It's kamikaze-style football. And on this occasion, they kill themselves, and Damien Lynch takes the mark. Defensive 45 for Olds of variance.
So it's not unusual to see Lynch down in the back line. For Zavs, works at the centre wing, out of sight of the ground. So Papo down towards the front of the pack with a fisted punch. Sees the ball over the line out of play. So Lynch has gone down back. He's not playing a loose man, is he, Andrew? No, he's got an opponent, hasn't he?
Yep.
Yeah, Jarvis. Thrown back in, out of sight of the ground. Up they go, Nethersole won the tap. Ball gets in the way, held up. We'll have another ball up. 60 playing, 49. 17 and a half gone, final terms. Zavs have the lead.
Go.
Thrown in the air, Nethersole won it down again, ball stole it. Kick along the ground towards the boundary line. They're looking for deliberate. He won't play it.
Barnaby Willis, the feeling at ground level. De La got the roll.
Very tense, boys. Very tense. Yeah, they've got a bit of a roll. One more and, boy.
Might pay you to go up the De La cell end with those supporters, Barnaby, and just get a bit of atmosphere up there. Not that I'm telling you what to do or anything.
I don't think he's excited anymore. He's fallen off the perch.
Up they go again. Out of side, so Papo fisted towards the boundary line. Out of play, we'll have another ball in centre wing, out of side.
18 minutes gone of the final term. Olds of variance, 9-6-60. They've only kicked one minor in this term. De La Sell kicked 3-1, and they're up to 7-7-49. They're finishing the better, De La Sell. Probably got about 8 or 9, maybe 10 minutes left in the grand final. Free kick pulled out on this occasion to Old Zaverians, and I think it'll go to Dynan. Chips the ball very, very short. Up there to Darvell, who takes the mark. Centre wing position, outer side of Elstonwick Park. Goes very long. Up they go in the air. Down the comes. It comes down to De La Sell. Free kick for above the shoulder. The Zavs play, supporters don't like it, but De La will get it, and they'll go into the centre, and low. The captain nearly took the mark. He recovers well. Gets a handball away to Nethersole. Oh, the running handball, overlapping. Now they're starting to finish well. Fenton's got the football through the centre, up to half forward. Knocked away from Oakley, over the top of Maloney. Crucial play. Comes back to Sapupo for Old Zaps. He was smothered. De La have now got the numbers. They've got five coming through the centre. One of them's the captain in low. Goes up to the 200 gamer. And Michael Duggan, who was a brilliant kick of the football, will kick from 45 metres out directly in front. And missed to bring De La Sell back to one kick.
He just confused his opponent then. He sort of went one way, then the other, and just found a little bit of space, and his opponent didn't know where he got to, and he just found about 3 or 4 metres in the clear, and they spotted him up.
No wind. Michael Duggan, he'll kick from 48 metres directly in front. Left foot, pushing, and pushing to the right, and only one minor score. 7-8-50 De La, 9-6-60 Old Zaverians on the dinner for eight. Scoreboard, 20 gone, last quarter, grand final.
So probably only 8 minutes to go, based on all of the other quarters so far to date. And look at the players for this kick-in. Bowen goes as long as he can in front there. Win, someone got in front of him there. It was Mannix. Loose ball now, came to Vickers. He can use Fields in. He can go into goal if he wants to. He goes in towards goal, a bounce. Well, a bounce. Oh. It nearly did. I think I wished it did, but
yeah,
it nearly came back.
You're doing a lot of
wow.
He was the right player to have the ball from that position, though, wasn't he?
He was.
He's such a lovely kick.
So just one missed opportunity. Bowen has to do it again. What will he do? He'll go to Fleming. Fleming in trouble, though. No. He got there in the nick of time, just outside the 45-metre arc. Glenn Huntley right into the ground. 9 points the margin. Zavs have the lead. 21 minutes gone, final term. Fleming with the footy. Goes with a kick. Centre wing. Sapupo will set himself. In front. Will he mark? No. Ball fell to Howard. High tackle. Umpire said, give it to me. Gee, I thought he was straight into him. From here.
Boy.
Well, Jared Maloney's just getting up holding his head. So Howard got up last. Umpire throws the ball in the air. Sapupo and Nethersole won the tap. Ball nearly stolen.
Ooh.
By Colbert, but getting it away, Dine, and umpire again says, give it to me.
He just grabbed the ball in Dine and virtually sat there and said, I'm not even going to try. I think he's pretty lucky to get away with it.
9 points the margin. Zavs have the lead. 21 and a half gone, final turn. Ball with it. Goes to ground with it. I want another ball up.
60 plays, 51. Nearly 22 minutes gone in the final term. This has been De La Sell's quarter. They still need another couple of goals. They don't need any more ball ups, and they're going to get one more at the moment.
Michael, De La Sell have got four players in a 5 metre radius, just 5 metres out from their goal square. There's a couple out further. They've just got to drag a couple of players out. It's too crowded in there.
At least they've got five forwards, so that means there's not going to be as many stoppages here. Dynan sitting on top of the football again, refusing to let it go. And once again, we'll get a restart. Right in front of us here, centre wing position. Great crowded sports cover this afternoon. They've witnessed an arm wrestle for most of the day where Old Zaverians had it, but De La are finishing the better. They need two goals. Purse gets the takeaway. On this occasion, Dynan nearly sits on the football. Old Zaverians, that's all they're trying to do. De La trying to break free.
Oh, that's
free
right.
Kick will go to Agius for Old Zav.
So Agius at halfback wants to move it quickly. He saw them move. He goes towards half forward. Up they go on. Gee, in front, Howard. Nick Smith ends up with the footy. Kick towards Larkins, and he takes the mark about 50 out from goal. Goes to Hanley in the pocket. Will he make it? No. Tripping in there is Clark. Couldn't hold on to it. Came here towards Maloney. Handball Corrin. Handball back. Kyle Williams. Handball to close in trouble. Goes along the boundary line. Fields end up. No. Can't hold on to it. Good spoil there by Rogerson. Ball over the boundary line. Centre wing. 23 and a half gone, final turn. 9 points the margin. Sabs have the lead. Purse got it down. Ooh. Hold on to there, low. Surely a free kick. And he'll get it. Now the forwards will start to get nervous. Kazoo wants it. Harrison goes to centre half forward. Kick off the side of the boot, though, it may go out. No, it'll stay in. Handball towards the boundary line. Umpire says ball it in. 55 out from De La Salle's goal.
Worked pretty well today, Brad Rogerson. Nearly 24 minutes gone in the 2009 VAFA A Section Grand Final. Old Zavarians are 9-6-60. De La Salle 7-9-51. The margin's 9 points. Nick DiMartino looking for the boundary line and finding it ahead of the danger man in Fields End. The two Woodrow medalists, Ken, come into the fore in the last quarter. Fields End and low after quiet starts.
Yes, been good. I agree with that. Yep.
Ruck contest, Purse been very good. It only came down to Pickett. Now Fields End underneath.
Oh, it's got to be. It's got to be.
This occasion didn't really disguise his decision to get the ball over the line and out of bounds.
I think he might have been playing 5 years ago when that was the only way to defend.
Well, yeah, I think he could have done a little bit more less than
Jesus.
That.
That's going to hit
but
Elwood
the
Beach.
Free kick will go to Matthew Fields, and it's a tough kick for a left footer. So he says, ooh, I'm going to share, and I'll share with you, Daniel Close. He's still probably too far out to score. Close. He'll be 50 metres out. He's just going to kick it up to the top of the goal square. They need a hanger. Dela, no. Mark taken, ball bottom of the pack. Serafini out to Ryan Colbert. Going backwards to Bowen. And Bowen just finds the boundary line on this occasion. We'll throw it in. 25 minutes gone. 9-6-60, 7-9-51. Zavs have it by 9.
Gee, Mannix only took the mark of the year with that. Thrown back in. Up they go. Oakley in front. Purse at the back. Got the tap down. Hale there. And Duggan. They're all there. And we'll have another ball up about 40 out from De La Salle's goal. 9 points the margin. 25 and a half gone. Zavs have the lead. Thrown in the air again. Third man up there was Pickett, and a kick out of bounds on the full from Zavs. Resultant free kick will go to Vickers. Now will he have a shot?
He's ball touched.
Okay. So touched. Fair enough.
I had the binoculars on Simon Lethlean then too, and his sigh of relief was very apparent.
Purse got it down. Now a chance there. Kick away by Ben Oakley, but it's straight in the arms of Lynch. Rebounds it back towards half back and close.
Out in the full.
Falling over has taken the mark.
Out the full.
No, yep. He's paid the mark. Close has got it.
Same result.
60 out from goal. Goes towards top of the square. Harrison in front. Got it down. Who races onto it? It'll be Howard. He's tackled by Vickers inside the 45 metre arc. 9 points the margin. Zavs have the lead. 26 and a half gone. Final turn. Inside the 45-metre arc for Dillard, Glenn Huntley right into the ground. Colbert tries to break clear. Great tackle by Roberts. Player screaming for a free kick, but he's not going to get one.
Well, I mean, to be consistent there, Russell Davidson, that sort of thing's just been paid a ball up all day, so I think it'd be...
Absolutely right.
Restart. Purse up in the ruck contest. Zavs have got all the numbers around the football. That's all they want to do. They want to create stoppage after stoppage. And they're still getting it. D-Law need 2 goals. Played 27 minutes of the final term. Zavs only 1 minor score in the final quarter. D-Law have kicked 3 goals, 3. You wouldn't think the quarter would go too much more than 29. And Zavs have got the footy. On this occasion, it's Nick Wynn. Been brilliant. He'll turn it over, though. It only goes as far as Tom Maloney. He's got 34 players in front of them. One of them's his teammate in Fenton. Runs through the centre. Up towards half forward. Getting back was Purse. Dela have the numbers, but Old Zavarians have the ball, and one of them's Darvell. He goes up towards Hanley. Hanley stands, gets the handball away. They chip the ball right up towards Fenton again, who takes it for Dela.
So Fenton and half back away they go again. Kick towards the outer side to Close. He marks centre wing. Outer side of the ground brings it in towards Jared Maloney. A handball here to Hale. Hale goes towards half forward for Dela to Howe. No, has he taken the mark? Pickett, yes. He's paid the mark to Pickett.
Might be too far out still.
45 out from goal.
Just got to go to the goal square.
Just top of the square. Just put it in there. He'll go as long as he can. Top of the square. Mannix sets himself.
Got it! Nice pull play on.
He's paid a mark to Harrison.
He paid a free kick to Maddox after the mark.
And he's put it through for a goal.
No, he said you've got to go back.
hurry up.
Confusion reigns at Elsenwick Park Sports Cover Arena.
So Harrison and Maddox were both there. Who's going to end up with it? It is going to be Harrison. So Harrison shots on goal to bring him back within 3 points. They've gone 29 minutes. Final term, and he's done it. It'll go back to the middle for another go. Sam's on 9.660. De La Salle 8.957. 29 gone, final term. 3 points the margin.
Can you mention, I think in the third quarter, that that was maybe one of the early touches that, or the only touches that Harrison had. I think he's probably kicked two of the most important goals of the game.
Oh, I think you're right. I think he's only had two touches.
We said we wanted a cracker. Most of the day we thought we were in for a stinker, but we've got the cracker now. It's 60-57. 29 and a half minutes gone. Cameron Peirce wins it out for Old Zavarians. Up towards Ben Corrin and Matt Hanley. One-on-one. Corrin gets a mid-air kick away. Chasing it was Hanley. Oh, coming through, Hanley looking for the boundary line. There it is! Time has been the nemesis here of De La Salle this afternoon. But congratulations to Old Zavarians, who controlled the match for most of the day. And 29 minutes and 50 seconds into the last quarter, the siren sounded. The 2009 VAFA Premiers are Old Zavarians, 9-6-60 over a gallant De La Salle, 8-9-57. Ken Petrucco, super game of footy in the end.
Oh, fantastic effort there at the finish by De La Salle. They really gave it everything. Everything that they had. I think David Madigan would be very pleased with that effort, because they were a long way down in the general play for three quarters of the day.
Well done, boys.
And I think it's just a mighty effort to fight back like that. It gives them a lot of heart for...
Are you there, boys?
Thanks, Ken. Barnaby Willis.
We've got Simon Lethlean. How's your heart, Simon?
Yeah, not particularly great. I don't, I've played in those games, and it's easy being out there too. You can't much play out from the box, but we had a guy go to the timekeepers and just call our mobile saying there's 15 seconds to go, so not personal, but you were okay. But, yeah, look, they are a great club, and they work amazingly hard, and they're so dangerous when the ball flicks out, so they're pretty hard to stop.
And just that last breakaway, as you said, with Peirce, it was one of those emphasis, the contested ball, making everything a scrap. Just a fantastic display for four quarters.
Yeah, look, I thought out as many stops as we could get, we were going to win. They're too dangerous when the ball gets flicked around. So, you know, Darvell was huge, and Peirce there was amazing. And look, it's just a great win. It's a terrific club. And, you know, our captain's been one of the best players in the comp for 12 years, and he deserves to be standing on a dais as a captain of the Premiership club, so it's great.
And how does it feel to be the Premiership coach?
Yeah, look, it'll sink in the next few days. It's we put a lot of work in. Our assistant coaches put in a power of time, and it's great. It's amazing.
Fair to say you'll let the leash off now?
Yeah, look, I will, mate. I've got a pretty busy week at work as well, but we'll really enjoy it. And, you know, this is as good a 22 a bunch of people as we've had at the club, so they deserve some success. It's great.
And on behalf of 96.5 NRFM, I just want to thank you, Simon. You've been fantastic this year. Very happy to come to the microphone, and none happier than today.
Yeah, people do say I like to hear my own voice, and maybe that helps out. But no, look, you guys have been great. Great coverage of the game, and it just it brings a new element to the comp to have a bit of radio coverage. So thanks to all you guys.
Have a great night.
Thanks, boys.
Welcome back to Sports Cover Arena, Elsenwick Park. And Old Zavarians have won their 11th VAFA Senior Premiership.
Please welcome one of the VAFA's true greats, a man who won twice in A section, twice the medal first and fairest in B section, and once in C section. A Victorian representative between 1957 and 64, a Carlton captain in 62 or 64, captain of the All Australian team, the 280 game veteran of Melbourne High School All Boys, the great J.F. Jock Nelson.
Professional player,
And now as we present the premiership medallions to the players, please welcome former A Section Premiership and Victorian coach, VAFA President Ed Bird. Thank you, Michael. Ladies and gentlemen, I think what we've witnessed here today is one of the truly great A-grade premierships. A magnificent contest, all we've all been after, one that kept us on the edge of our seats until the very last minute, and it certainly did that. And the D-Lar boys, fantastic, and never gave up. They were a young side, as I said before, you stopped the rising to all the boys, and Marty, the President. I'm sure we'll see you back here over the next few years. Fantastic year, congratulations. For the old Bavarians, the President Simon Hunt, Coach Simon Lethlean, Captain Hughes Lincoln, the team, a magnificent effort. You're put under extreme pressure in that last quarter, but to your credit, your health firm, and Simon Rank, and he's done it again. So, performance and a fantastic year. Well done, fellas. Number 9, Damien Lynch. Number 10, Andy Ryan. Number 11, Luke Howard. Number 12, Andrew Bowen. Number 14, Josh Aegis. Number 15, Chris Smith. Number 16, Brad Rogerson. Number 18, Darnell. Number 19, Tim Dylan. Number 24, Cameron Purse. Number 26, Wynn. Number 29, Matthew Hadley. Number 30, Tim Clark. Number 31, Matthew Ball. Number 34, Ryan Colbert. Number 36, Good Samoho. Number 37, Nick Brunatina. Number 41, Esmond Frost. Number 53, John Gaffuri. Captain, number 8, Tim Fleming. Sports Motor Cup, and VAFA President Nick Burke presents the L.A. Edison Cup to all Zavarians.